Just like that, come my way. Just my shit. Doja Cat, call me Elgato. I'm the big boss and I got big bread. I'm getting big headed and I like good head. I'm not cheap, baby, and I'm sure not selfish. Taking like Elvis down to broke my pelvis. Jumping off the top rope, got them tag teaming. Putting on a show, I got the whole crowd screaming. Bougie with the bread, I'm like a top notch freak. Act like I'm a treat when a dog see me. Like a thief in the night, it like she stole my green. Got me walking off the scene like a hole in my jeans.
What's up, boys? Hello, hello, hello. What's guaning, my drillers? Hello. Yes, oh, it didn't work. Ah, it didn't work. It didn't work. You couldn't mute me, bitch. Oh, I'm glad you just got scammed. I am glad you just got scammed, pussy. How much did that cost you? Huh? How much did that cost you, bitch? No one can silence me. No one can silence me. Please tell me the whole VOD didn't fucking go off. Bro, this fucking cat. Hello?
Hello?
Bro, it unplugged the fucking the Ethernet. How I have like I have a hub underneath my desk where I use the main Ethernet connecting to all my systems, like my PS5, my Xbox, and my Switch. And the power that goes into that little box comes out really easily. I would show you, but it would end my stream. Stop lying! I'm not lying! Yo, hello? Hello? Yo. Thug Shaker Thursday. Yeah, you have to be invited to the after party, man. That is an after party, brother. That is not a mainstream thing. If you're not invited, you're not a part of the cool kid club, man. I don't know what to tell you. We back. We lit. Sometimes when I'm lonely, I sing and think about him, and it hurts to remember all the good times when I thought I could never live without him. And I wonder, does it have to be the same every time when I see him? Will it bring back all the pain? What's up, boys? How are we all doing today? Hello, good afternoon, good morning, good evening, wherever you are in the world. Everyone's having a fantastic day. How we doing, boys? How we doing? Who's here today? I'm going to say hello to everyone who puts a happy. Let's say hello to everyone. You also ask HP, Joni, General. Oh, God, there's a lot of people here. Matt's boy, Jay Fern. Why is there so many people here today, man? Zoomers. A Yerman, Zanchi, Rebak, Curtis, Anerso, Glock, Muzo, what's up, man? Juggalo, Horny, Velstor, Island Monkey, what's up? Bro, please, chill. Thank you. Okay. Get off the shit king! Get off the shit king, bro! Yo, what's up, Noxious? What's up, Avicii Quinn? Fulgum, Stun, Sky Soju, Koopa, what's up, Kuneg, Pluto? Boys, welcome to the stream. Everyone's having a fantastic day. Wait. Why can't I scroll? Why isn't my scrolling function working on my mouse? Oh my god. How? Bro, he's fucked it! How the fuck do you save that? How do you fix it? Oh, I didn't fix it. There we go. Oh my fucking god. Wait, I wanted to say hi to one last person. Just gonna pick one random. General Flesh. Fleischer, what's up, brother? Yeah. What's up, man? So, how are we feeling today on a scale of 1 to 10? How is everyone doing? 8. Oh shit! What is this, a mo? Greg. Oh, it's a Greg Knockham off a mo. Bro, there's a bunch of fucking Greg riders in here, bro. Holy fuck. You guys are some riders. So, do you like this emote? Why is he crying? Why does the eggplant have veins on it? Okay, Twitch emotes are becoming shit. Greg, listen. Bro, this isn't an emote, Greg. You gotta make... Greg, what is that, man? Greg, bro. Mad. Oh my god, bro. Yeah, this... I didn't make this an emote. This is... this is a fucking dumb emote, bro. I never picked it, though. Okay, man. Oh, my Lord. What is happening to State of Twitch? Chat, yesterday, I went and watched the Mario movie. Oh, my God. Dude, it was so good. Chat, it was so good, bro. It was actually good. I'm telling you, don't listen to those boomer reviews. Go watch it, man. Go, it's actually worth the watch. Go watch it. Alright? Okay? And now I'm gonna get back at you motherfuckers for spoiling everything throughout the years, okay? I'm gonna get back at you fuckers. Because I watched it first, bitch. Okay, so it starts off in Brooklyn. Alright, and Mario and Luigi have just quit their job at a construction company. And they decide to make their own plumbing company. Okay? So they're going around and they're looking to create, you know, a big boom for them. So they make an ad for... you can't mute me, bitch! It don't work! I bet there's actually some mad people in here. Look, I'll leave it at that, okay? I won't spoil it. My fault. I won't spoil it. Alright? Don't spoil shit for me anymore. How about that? Movie sucks and you haven't seen it. How would you know? How would you know? How do you know? Because I'm horny. Well, no horny people allowed. I'm sorry, man. Why isn't anything working today? Why are no emotes working and shit, bro? Why are no emotes working and shit? Moz, you can unban him. In the overlay, look at this shit. Nothing's working. What happened to 7TV? Is there beef with BTTV actually like knocked him off the map? Yes. It's so fucking cringe. Why is BTTV being like that? That's so cringe, man. Did you take your Switch to the theater? Yeah, I did. I did. And I played Mario Kart. I took my Switch and I was gaming while watching this shit. I was first place, man. Look at me. First place is Yoshi on... Well, this is Yoshi's Island. Actual loser. This shit was boring as fuck, bruh. I needed something to do. You took it to the theater just for the bit? Admit it. No, I was playing Mario Kart. I was legit playing Mario Kart during the Mario Kart section. Like, there's a Mario Kart section in the movie, and I literally loaded up Rainbow Road and played it at the same time as them, so I felt like it was a part of the movie. Spoiled, it's in the trailers, shut up. Yeah, it was like I was in the movie. Same joke 2 days in a row. It's still funny. I felt like I was in the movie, bro. I felt like I was in the movie. Did you have to pay for two seats? No. Bro, I don't know what it is. When you book a ticket, it says, like, you can't be close to anyone. It makes you put two seats away from anyone. So then you have two seats in between you can put shit on. So, yeah, it was fine. That's just for you. No, it's not. No, it's not. So I had three seats, technically. I didn't buy three seats, but I had three seats. One of them had my bag on it. One of them had my bag on it. I sat in the middle one, and on my right I had my popcorn and my drink. Yeah, I got popcorn, okay? I had a bit of popcorn. Yep, I had a bit of popcorn. I'm not relapsing. I had a bit of popcorn because I was having a bad day. I had a really bad day yesterday, okay? There was a lot of shit that happened that wasn't fun. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to have a treat at the end of the night. I'm going to watch the Mario movie. And I'm going to eat a bit of popcorn. So I ate a bit of popcorn, bro. All right? There's nothing wrong with a little bit of treat every now and then. All right? You guys get yourself some. You heard? Hey, ain't nothing wrong with treating yourself every now and then. All right, sis? Ain't nothing wrong with it. You actually deserve a treat. Yes, I do. I agree. Where's Warbo? His name's Bento, and I have no idea where he is. Oh, never mind. He's playing in a box. Show Maggot. Bro, these names are getting out of hand, chat. No, bro. No.
I love you guys.
We're not calling him Bento. You'd rather call him fucking Warbo. Bro, it's ugly. Your name's Gooba. You can't say it. Bro. No. You are not good at names. Your name's Gooba. You're called Warwick. Okay, I didn't name myself, did I, bitch? I didn't name myself. You fucking named yourself. I didn't name myself. Zoyo's a good name. Four letters, short, memorable. It's a great name. Tell me Zoyo isn't a good name, bro. That is classic. That is a classic. I'm gonna show. Show Kittler. Bro. Chat, he bites a lot. Is that normal for a kitten? Like, when he plays, he'll like attack my feet and hands. How do I stop him doing that? Orange cat behavior. Is he gonna be a cunt? Is he gonna be an actual cunt or what? Oh my god. No, don't say orange cat's Pepe Lau. What the fuck? He'll bite my arm, he'll bite my hand, and if I don't move it, he'll start licking my fingers. And then if I move my finger, he'll bite it again. So I don't get it. So I just move him, I just pick him up and I put him off the bed or whatever. My friend has two ginger Maine Coons and they are assholes. I'll make sure he's not an asshole, bro. He's just inquisitive. He's exploring. He's, you know. You don't need a friend. I don't need to. Oh my god. What color is your cat? He's. Her paint job is asshole orange. He's cute though. No, as in ass. Look. As in he is an asshole. Not as. You guys are weird, bro. You guys are weird. Thoughts on the Mario movie? I think the Mario movie was a great film. Bro, I saw some reviews on Rotten Tomatoes that, like, if you don't understand, if you've never played a Mario game, the movie doesn't appeal to you at all. There's not really this. The movie's just a lot of Easter eggs. I'm like, who the fuck do you think it's made for, bitch? Well, no fucking shit. It's literally the Mario movie. What the fuck are you typing? These reviewers are actually brain dead, bro. The reviewers are brain dead. Look at the Rotten Tomato reviews. Bro, They gave it a 53, but the audience gives it a 96. They are stupid. They're stupid, bro. Like, get off the... It's all this... Birringtingly wrote, aside from bursts of weird vitality whenever the film veers into action out of the games. What? What does that even mean? This isn't a movie. It's a checklist of fan expectations. Oh, they gave the fans what they wanted. Therefore, it's not a movie. Odie Henderson, mate, it's time to get in the box. It's time, mate. You are fossilizing. You need to get in there. Holy fuck. What? What does that even mean? It was a great movie. It was a great movie, bro. I'm not paid by Nintendo. I'm just saying. Doesn't have the coolness or cutting edge appeal as, say, the Lego movie did. Tom Santilli, bro. Bro. And it wasn't quite as fun as Sonic the Hedgehog. Fuck off! Sonic the Hedgehog was shit! What the fuck? This guy is high. This guy had a Sega Genesis. He did not have a fucking Nintendo growing up. This kid was deprived of good games. Alright? He was deprived of good games. But it's a mildly enjoyable, family-friendly adventure that does just enough to make it feel like a success. So it was good. It was good. I haven't seen Sonic 2. Sonic 1 was a good movie, okay? But Mario movie... It was good, bro. Like, there were so many good parts that, like, it's just sick. I don't want to spoil it. It was just fun. It was fun, bro. I was going into it thinking it was going to be shit, and it was just fun. So, have you seen this? Bro, stop linking Dua Lipa, bro. Cody Leach. Let's see what this Leach has to say.
Got me.
The Super Mario Bros. Relies heavily on nostalgia and the joy of its wacky and colorful world. The voice acting is hit or miss and the story feels light and rushed. It still manages a fun family outing. It's a nice starting point on the franchise. Huh. Bro, it's very colorful and fun, okay? And also the voice acting was good. I thought I was going to hate Chris Pratt's voice as Mario, but I actually didn't mind it. When I was watching it, I didn't mind it at all. Yeah, I liked it, man. Seth Rogen, Donkey Kong, yeah, that shit felt a little bit out of place, I'm not gonna lie. Especially when he did the fucking dumbass laugh. Like, bro, that shit was annoying, I'm not gonna lie. I have no words to hear the fucking laugh, bro. It wasn't fine, it was fine. How is Jack Black? Bowser didn't get as much screen time as I thought he was gonna get, you know? But he was good. It was good. Alright. Senny leaked this video of you if you were... Can I read? Senny leaked this video of you. If I were you, I would go offline. What the fuck is that? Bro. That's got to be TOS. What the fuck was that? Okay. Let's get him. Jesus fucking Christ, man. So these are your viewers.
This man never saw a woman his entire life.
Who the fuck is this?
Yeah.
Joe Toes, I don't know why, you just like, you look like you smell of cat pee. I know what it is, bro.
Real RX. I used to wake up in my room in the morning, put on my dirty shoes in the morning, heard mama crying last night.
This man never saw a woman his entire life.
That's wild, bro. I would not have been posting those pictures willingly. That was a little toxic. Oh, my fault. Maybe I'll get hand a bit back of toxicity every bit of now and then, you know? You guys literally hurl at me every single day. You can't take it back. You can't take it back, huh? Bro remembered he was streaming. When did they add this skin into the game? When did they add that one? For Easter? I've never seen a hitbox that wide. Like, not okay. This is so dumb. This is actually stupid. Like, no resemblance whatsoever. Zero, bro. Zero fuckers. My father told me when I was just a child. These are the. One sec. I need to get some water chat. These are the nights.
Shining, always go. I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good.
What is this? But yeah, this doesn't look anything fucking like me, bro. What is he even wearing? Nobody's calling this a casual outfit. That is literal leather. There's zero resemblance, man. There's not. This is you 3 years ago. He looks like he has like the same build as that Titan character from fucking Megamind. You know what I mean? Oh, Jesus, man. Jesus. Yo, thanks for the 4 months gifted full gum. To it's Lena. Thank you, man. Milk Mop, thanks to 11 months. Colossal Swift, thanks to 16. Mr. Softy, thanks to Prime. Spectral NZ, thanks to 17 months. To comment on this. What? Comment on this. Okay. What is this? Bro, I haven't heard this song in forever. Holy shit.
Nuke Radio, we make your eardrums bleed.
I just shoved a nuke up my pussy.
What? That's one of the hardest producer tags in the biz, probably. Probably. Zoyal, I made this cool 2 second video for you. What you got for me, ma'am? Uh, there. That didn't work.
How about a nice big cup of shut the fuck up?
He actually doesn't press it.
Think before Thank you open much. Your stupid mouth, jackass.
Yeah, I
oil check DMs, bitch. Texpo angry.
DMs?
Oh, busted.
Oh.
Little cookie on the way to the gym. Now, this doesn't count as a meal.
Those packages are getting a bit lonely on your sofa. Don't want the uranium to go fast. It's sell by date now, do we?
Dude, listen. I want to wait until we have a lot of packages to a PO Box opening stream. I'm sorry you guys have to wait, all right? But there's going to be a PO Box opening stream eventually. I'm not going to just leave them unopened, am I? All right? It's going to have to wait a little longer. So, people are sending more. When I am with you, there's no place I'd rather be. The food I sent is gonna go bad, Zoil. I'll eat it still, don't worry. I'll still eat it, man. Which one's your package? Is your package even back here? Was you one of the first people that sent one, Sims? I didn't send one. Okay, shut up then, man. Bro, you guys make problems out of nothing, I swear, bro. God damn! I'm gonna put my camera on.
Oil, open my one, please. It can be a toy for the kitty cat.
When I am with you, there's no place I'd rather be. Oh, I look sick. Bro. Chat, you would not approach me on the street. If I walked up to you looking like this, you ain't approaching me, bro. Like, you'd be scared. You'd be terrified. Wait, why is this camera on? Oh my god, I'm not wearing any pants. Why is that on?
I made you an outro song for stream check DMs.
Six foot 11, I am not fighting you. Good, and remember that, okay? Remember that. Remember who you're talking to when you type stuff in chat. Remember. You look so goofy. All right, Ninja Cat. Let's see how you look, man. Post your Instagram. I'm not kidding. Post your Instagram right now. Ninja Cat, post your Instagram. Post it. Come on.
I can ride my bike with no handlebars. No handlebars.
No, don't meme. No, you can't meme and say post it. I want you to post it. This ain't a joke, buddy. No. Post. Who is he? You're talking to yourself? Post it, bitch. Okay, he's actually on one. No. Mate, just say you're scared, Ninja Cat. Tell us you're scared. Okay, bro, this guy. This fucking guy. That is an actual AI. That has to be an AI. That's a Linebot fucking 3000. Right? Was I supposed to read it? I wasn't reading. I'm sorry. I wasn't reading. Okay, I just downloaded a fucking video. Please let me be some weird shit.
Having sex with a vagina is for absolute pussies. You know what a real man does? As a real gangsta myself, I take it in the ass. That's what real G's do with their bros. I'll tell you something. I may be known as top G in public, but here in my cell in Romania, I'm known as the bottom G. That's how we roll. I cannot think of a lower ROI activity than sticking your dick in pussy. It's a complete waste of time and energy. Just think about it for a second. Them hoes have taken literally millions of cock. It just ain't tight enough for me. But drilling a fellow G's ass, now that is completely a different story.
What is ROI, chat? What does ROI mean? Return on interest. Return on investment. Oh. You meant in that case. Okay, I get it. I get what you're saying now. No, I get what you're saying. I didn't realize it meant in that context the same thing. What does return on investment mean?
I'm the predator, the free, and the fire.
Not watching the rest of that. I didn't say it, bro. I never said it in that clip. Who fucking linked that? Musa, bro. I never said it, okay? Just so we all know. So we're all clear. The most immature among us VR conversation.
So big diarrhea, that's what she did when changing diapers.
Your mama's so dumb, she can't even count to one.
Your mama's so big and fat and daddy, and your boyfriend, your mama's husband left
Whoa.
Your dad is so ugly, I could kiss him.
You smell like a nigga.
What?
Your mama's
Bro, holy fuck. Bro, that was wild. That was fucking wild. What the fuck? Dude, the imposter just saved that kid. Bro, the imposter saved him from being cancelled later down his fucking life. Bro. That was wild. I was the kid. Oh no, I was like that as a kid. Okay. Jesus fucking Christ, man. Oh. That was wild. Who's he been hanging around to know this shit?
Each of our lovely ladies to lie back in the water and see who's most buoyant.
What the fuck is this?
The pair with the natural pair. Marquetta?
I'm sorry, what? I'm telling my grandkids this was Andrew Tate.
Excellent, well done, thank you. Good floating. Right then, Haley, let's see how your silicon-enhanced breasts do in the float test.
What is this? So this is not an experiment. Like,
not bad. In fact, that's quite puzzling.
That is literally Andrew Tate, bro. What the fuck? What was that link? Nah, bro. Nah.
No.
Coke or Pepsi? This is of interest to you. Pepsi. Pepsi Max is the best soft drink ever made. Pepsi Max is literally the best shit, bro. It's so much better than Coke. I do not care. It's so much better.
Coke or Pepsi?
I think it depends on what I'm eating. If I'm having a burger, I definitely want a Pepsi. If I'm having...
Okay, you don't have to put this much fucking thought into it. What? No, bro, you did not buy both and be like, I really fancy the Coke with it. No, they're the same shit pretty much.
Like pizza. I think I want my mom's sweet, creamy milk.
Coke or Pepsi?
I like to drink my mom's sweet and creamy breast milk right from the tap.
Coke or Pepsi?
Milk.
Coke or Pepsi?
We're not really like soda people.
We just like to drink his mother's sweet, sweet breast milk.
Carbonated.
It's got bubbles. Very fizzy.
Coke or Pepsi?
I like to drink half and half out of my mommy's jugs.
It's sweet, it's creamy, it's rich, it's what I need.
Tastes like Honey Nut Cheerios.
Hey mom, I'm on my way home. Get them ready. Get it ready.
Okay. Alright, thanks for that link, man. Thank you. W emote, please add this. Ew. I was sick. I was sick when that happened, okay? I was ill. That's not funny to make fun of that. I can't help but Zoyo, look at this. Schedule your calendar refreshing. Bro, stop linking this, please. Nobody says shit. How I'm
supposed to act when my morals. Oh my god, iSpice just joined my stream. Yo, what's up, iSpice? Yo, it's iSpice. Yo, link in bio. iSpice just joined my stream. Oh, good God.
You guys tag me in so many fucking TikToks now. This one guy, Gegzy Meg, you tag me in like every fucking TikTok you come across. I swear to God, bro. Every single one you come across, you like just tag me in it. Let me look at them, bro. Let me look at them. They better be funny. If not, you gotta stop tagging me, alright? You gotta stop tagging me if they're bad. Okay, terrible.
Check this out, boys. Here, man, show them. I've not been, man.
No Stellas equals no teeth.
Teeth out, lads. I've told her if you don't wash me pots, I'll get me Stellas. That's what happens. Show them one more time.
What? This is the truth. The gnome truth. Gnomes are real. Okay, you need to stop linking me in these ones where I gotta read. Like, I don't wanna read all. Listen, I ain't trying to read all that.
So you dropped out of school, huh?
Hey, your mother asked you a question. Answer her.
I've already told you like 1,000 times, so.
What, be a bum? Is that what you wanna do? You wanna be a.
Okay, stop tagging me in TikToks, bro. If it's gonna be movies and reading.
When the days are cold. And the cards are gold. And the saints we see are made of gold. When the dreams are filled. And the ones we have are the worst of all. And the blood runs down.
I wanna hide the truth.
I wanna shelter you.
But with the beast inside,
there's nowhere we can hide.
No matter what we breathe,
we feel I'm made of greed.
This is my kingdom come.
This is my kingdom come.
When I feel the heat. How many times have you linked this specific one, bro? Shut up with John Paul. He looks like a chow chow. That is literally a chow chow. Right? Look. The dog, the fucking dog, bro.
Luke Radio.
Bread. What is it called? Bread. Okay. Bro, you need to stop tagging me, okay, mate? No more tags. No more tags. What was his name again? Gegzy Meg. Fedo. Zero more. This guy messaged me. Wait, what did Nate message me? This type of message isn't supported. Bro, what did you type to me? The fuck did you say to me? Like, holy fuck.
Tomfoolery is on the rise.
Let's see if I liked any good TikToks while I've been gone. I usually do.
Man, come on, man. What's it going on? Look, man, I swear he got a double cook, man, like he's drinking some alcohol.
What's up?
No, you can't put no more in
there,
bro.
He wants even more. This is literally me as a kid, bro. Yep. Add more now.
Just a little bit, please.
Go ahead, man. You can't, bro. Man, come on, man.
True, you get a free sip, chat. You get a free sip, then you add more. That is literally how it goes, man.
It's time to see what the crack is with this place. Get on the old Bisto there, £4.75 for gravy. Fuck me, it'd be cheaper to go to the chippy and buy four or five fucking pots than that, you rip off fucking Robin cunt. Fuck me, that cannot be for one tin. That is for one fucking tin. Holy Mary, mother of fucking God. £3.40 for some sauce, eh? But there are other versions available. Let me know if it's
you know what, that ketchup ain't even that bad. I've had that shit in the past. It ain't even that bad, bro.
I have to go down that route. Nearly £4 fucking quid in here for mini rolls. That's there in a fucking Tesco. What the fuck?
Check this
when
out. Also
the
look
fuck
at
did Space Invaders get
link
to £1.55? You literally get fucking three in a bag. You're having a laugh. I have to get a few tickets of this, just in case I want to do any more fucking shopping in this place. Someone said about Tropicana being in the fucking bargain bin. That's not a fucking bargain. Not at all, is it? You cheeky cunts.
Fucking hell, man.
Yeah, fuck off, Greggs. You rip-off cunts. Can you beat 50p from Poundland reduced? Literally can't. You charge 120 for a sausage roll. That was about 80p a year ago. You robbing cunt. Yeah, fuck off, Greggs. You rip-off cunts. Can you beat
Poundland meat and potato pasty? 50p. Bro, does it tell you what meat's in it? That is fucking mystery meat. Oh my god. Chat, tell me that ain't Cleveland Jr. That ain't LeBron, bro. Oh my god. These are all real. This is Amy Winehouse. Holy fuck, man. George Clooney. He looks like fucking Austin Powers.
When your feelings ain't protected, you cash some checks just to get some neck and some necklaces.
Chat, this is a proof that you can have a glow up, bro. This is proof you can have a glow up. Got a taste of it. Never was the same. Angelina Jolie. She looks older than 11 there. He looks younger than 16 there. What the fuck? There's no way he's 16 there. There's no, that is 8 years old.
Let's make something out of nothing.
The fuck I'm supposed to make? Ain't shit up in this motherfucker. The light don't even work in this bitch.
Let's make something out of nothing.
The fuck I'm supposed to make? Ain't
here. Here.
Jesus. Okay, that's it. That's all I liked. That's all I liked, boys. Fucking hell. Oh. And Emma Grzeb update. There's no way Emma Grzeb has posted anything new to the talk. There's no way. Generation money, type of money, dying rich. And I wanna say, shout out to the dead. Now I flex, whoa. She's gone private. Oh, let me follow you, please. Emma, let me follow. Bro, I beg, let me follow. Emma. Bro, what happened to her, chat?
For all the boys out there, I'm sorry, but I already have a partner.
This poor lady's been coming up my FYP a lot with a lot of stitches. And a lot of people have been horrible to her. You've got to take into account, she's still a human being.
True, man. Nah, true, man. On God, on God, on God.
I'm not even trying to be funny.
you're not. All right. Get me off of this website for a sec, boys. You nigga not ready to open the doors. You nigga run in. Zerl is a bully. I ain't bullying no one, man. I would never. As promised, FNAF fans, you asked and we will deliver. A FNAF movie is coming Halloween on October 27, 2023. Bro, I like FNAF, but I feel like it's become just like a furry shit now. It's like, it's actually become furry shit now. No, it actually has though. It actually has. You're coping if you're saying shut the fuck up. It actually has. It actually has though. It literally has. It has. Robot equals furry. I'm not saying it's intended to be that or the creators made it that. I'm saying the fans made it that, idiots. You're coping if you type question mark. You're coping. Chica, though. You're literally saying you want a fucking animal robot. And you're telling me this ain't furry? Nah, bro. You need to reflect. That's what I was going to say. Reflect, bro. On God, reflect. You need some self-reflection time. Guess I'm a furry then. Well, at least you're honest with yourself, man. Actually, it's anthropomorphic, not furry. Isn't furries literally an anthropomorphic character?
In the vision by the 13. I was 15. I was 16. I was 15. I was 16. I was 15.
Huh. Interesting. Zill proper scrad. What is this?
I was 16.
Day 160 of telling Zill what I'm eating. Why is it a 10-minute video? This is a guy that comments under every single one of my videos. Actually saying what he's eating. Bro, you're not making pasta with fucking baked beans on top. No, you're fucking not. Oh no, that's chili. Never mind, my fault. Alright, bro. Bro, it's not a cake! You don't need to cut it! You're giggling because you know you're fucking stupid! Why are you doing this? Oh my god. I kind of like it when the pasta's like a day old like this. When you reheat it, I don't know why. It has like a different taste that's nicer. No. Maybe it's because we used to do that a lot. Like we used to refrigerate the pasta because we'd have extra for the next day. Like, I don't know why, but like when you reheat it from being cold, it has like a different texture that's kind of nice. It's kind of nostalgic. Now you're a nasty fucker, bro. But you just cut the fucking pasta in half, bro. He's gonna eat it cold. Go on, get some of that ragu on there, bro. Stop fucking giggling. Get some of the ragu on there. Go on. Cold noodles are OP. Okay, I'm not saying cold. You reheat them. But like when they've been cold, I don't know what it is about them. It tastes good. just like, nah, fuck this. I give up. No gonna let me fucking see you put the ragu on, are you? Alright. I'm gonna chuck it in the microwave. Go on, mate. Put a little bit of salt and pepper on it. Come on. Bro, stop playing with the fucking food. What's that? Why have you just got a bowl? Why is there a bowl in your mic? What the fuck was that? Okay, man. Alright. Close the fucking fridge at least. Close the fucking fridge.
Howdy, sir. This is Agent Ross. I need you to come back and play Red Dead as there are so many criminals back.
Zoya, 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 now. Oh, Zoya, hey, please play Red Dead now. Do it now.
What the fuck is going on here, man? Shit, he's actually just made a meal and started doing push-ups like he's a fucking sim or something. Actually trying to increase his fucking skill levels. He's literally... Bro, what the fuck is this? What is it? Okay, well, I don't know what the fucking workout's called. Same shit, bro. Same shit, different move. But press up. Leg up. Fucking hip thrust. Who cares what it's called, bro? Kamehameha. Okay, where are you from? What country? We can tell by the fridge. Let's see what country. Okay, HP Brown Sauce is from the UK. Never mind. That's it. That's all I had to say. You've got some nice sinks though, man. You've got nice sinks there. I like those big, deep sinks, those farmhouse sinks. He literally did the fucking workout before he put the lids back on the food. Something about that just annoys me. Looks dire, doesn't it? It needs some bit of fucking seasoning at least. Like, you can put a little bit of cheese on there, maybe. Fucking salt and pepper. I don't fucking know. A couple parsley sprigs. Maybe some chili flakes. You know, spice it up a little bit. Oh, here we go. Is that a weed grinder? Bro. Okay, there we go. You did what I said. Salt. Good shit.
Hello, fat ass. I will not say this again.
Fucking
play Red Dead
hell.
Now. You should play Red Dead now.
Bro, I'm busy. I'm busy. Can you see I'm busy? Fucking hell. So how much salt do you fucking need? Bro, added half the fucking ocean to this bitch. I want spaghetti now, bro. I haven't had spaghetti in so long. It's been however long since I started this challenge. The last time I had spaghetti. Holy fuck. Wait, what is that milk? Okay, maybe he isn't from the UK. The fuck does that even say on it? Oh, that's some like Finnish shit. That's Finland. That's Finland. Bro, listen, I used to love a cold glass of milk when I was a youngster. But it would usually be like, you know, in the middle of the day or at night or in the morning, not with fucking food. How are you gonna drink a cup of milk with spaghetti? Easily. No, I'm sorry, spaghetti don't go with a glass of milk. You guys are just disagreeing to disagree because it's me. You would never drink a glass of milk with fucking spaghetti. You need a glass of red wine or rosé. You have to be baiting. Shut up, bitch. No, I'm not even talking to you anymore. Oh my God! Bro! Bro! Wait! What the fuck? Why did you decide to go for the milk this time? I thought it was maybe another option you could have fucking gone for. Did you run out? He's watching Danny. You went down a... It was 41 and you went to 40. You went back a day. With lots of salt. Pasta bolognese with lots of salt and drinking a glass of milk. Oh... I'm not watching this guy's videos daily. Bro. This is the first video he's released in 2 years, first of all. And second of all, what the f... Bro, I'm actually in shock of what I just watched. Like, that was... That was... Not okay. He added half the pot of salt. I don't know what I'm more concerned about. The amount of salt this guy puts on his food. Or literally, the radioactivity radiating from all those cans on his desk. He is dying. Like, he is dying. Says you. Says you two, we're all going to the same destination. We're all traveling further and farther, closer and closer to the sweet embrace of death. What is this? This turtle's still at it?
Feels weird, man. WTF did I tune into?
You know, so Charon Saint thinks that £8. Wait, someone told me to look at a video. Ollie is dead. What is this, man? I should test this with my cat. See if. Just see if my cat. What is this? Bro, you literally said this is a song you made for me, Ollie, and it says semi intro song. No, you have to make a new one. I'm not listening to it unless it's a new one, bro. Has to be brand new. Nope, you can't use it on both of us. Nope.
Yeah.
It's hot out here.
Yeah.
You want to take it back inside?
Yeah.
Okay. New Sunny this video B2. Will cover oh. Child celebrities who have terrible lives now. Wait a sec. This could actually be good.
This video will cover six child.
This could actually be good, chat.
Child stars who had a terrible life after fame. And we're going to begin by talking about Jake Lloyd, who played Anakin.
Oh my God, bro. What happened?
Jake Lloyd, who played Anakin Skywalker in Star Wars The Phantom Menace. Jake was chosen to play Anakin from 3,000 potential candidates and would perform so well in the billion-dollar movie that he won the best performance in a feature film for an actor under the age of 10. While this might have implied that Jake had a promising film career ahead of him, he'd appear in only one more movie after Star Wars before announcing his acting retirement at the age of 12, explaining that he was bullied heavily as a result of the role. My entire school life was really a living.
Bro, I don't understand kids, man. I genuinely do not understand. How can you get bullied for literally being in fucking Star Wars? Like, that's literally one of the coolest fucking things ever. Like, kids just don't make sense to me.
Hell, and I had to do up to 60 interviews a day. Other children were really.
It was 2000s, bro. These movies were made in 2000s.
Mean to me. They would make the sound of the lightsaber every time they saw me, with this kind of harassment even continuing into Jake's high school and college experience.
You know how they can be in high school. They're so charming and intelligent. College has been similar. They wouldn't let it go.
In other interviews, Jake had been warned about the common path taken by child celebrities.
Child stars have had a bit of a reputation that they turn to, you know, a life of drugs, so may the force be with you.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yet this advice.
Bro just straight up said, don't go down that path.
Seemed to have no impact as his life began to go downhill beginning in 2015. Jake Lloyd has schizophrenia, stopped taking his medication, and attacked his mother. Indianapolis police were called to the home of Lloyd's mother, Lisa. She said the 26-year-old showed up and yelled at her, saying she ruined his life. Lloyd allegedly knocked her down when she wouldn't let him in the house and stomped her 3 or 4 times, causing bruises and abrasions. He was gone by the time the police showed up and she didn't press charges. Only 3 months later, Jake Lloyd found himself in a high-speed police chase, after which he'd be arrested for reckless driving, driving without a license, and resisting arrest, resulting in 10 months jail time in a psychiatric facility. 2 years after this, Jake's 26-year-old sister Madison died unexpectedly in her sleep, prompting the mother to release a statement regarding Jake's well-being. Jake has been diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia, but unfortunately he also has a symptom called anosognosia, which causes a lack of insight into his illness. This only adds to the struggle he faces, which has been very difficult after the tragic loss of his younger sister, Madison. He has moved closer to his family, and we are all working hard to help him with this. He is still a kind and caring person, and we hope to have him back to his fun and entertaining self as soon as possible. Jake will continue to make progress with the love and support you continue to show, which is promising when compared to the life of Edward Furlong. After playing John Connor in The Terminator 2, Furlong began to mess with drugs, stating, "Hollywood effed me up, man. Lots of money and lots of free coke will turn anybody into a cokehead," with this addiction resulting in his first arrest for driving under the influence without a license. Furlong attended rehab as a result of the incident and was able to stay sober for a number of years. However, by 2009, at the age of 32, he was back in the news for punching his girlfriend whilst on drugs. 3 years later, Furlong was arrested
drugs
again,
and domestic
this
abuse.
Time for domestic
fucking
abuse
hell.
Against his new girlfriend, resulting in a further 6 months in prison, where he'd pick up a meth addiction, although this story actually has somewhat of a happy ending. In July 2022, Furlong announced that he had gotten his
that's a like the fucking Joker. There's a pearly white.
He's fixed, was taking better care of himself, and had been sober for over 4 years.
I'm much happier now, man. I mean, that's it nice. Feels so good to at least be doing the best you can.
Although this kind of happy ending has been unavailable to...
Bro didn't age one bit. What the fuck? He did not age. Could you even call him a child star? How old was he in Drake and Josh, chat? How old was he there? He was 16? No way he's 16. Bro, teenagers in like Nickelodeon and Disney shows were always played by like 20-year-olds. If you think back on it, that's probably why being a teenager looked so scary, bro. These were grown-ass adults playing children. I was like, bro, I don't want to be that big ever. They were straight-up old adults, bro. They were old, playing children. Zoe 101 was 15. Zoe 101 had a... Did I watch Zoe 101? Wait, what is Zoe 101? Oh, this one. This is a good show. This is a good show.
Are you ready?
Ooh, I know it's standing there. That was good.
Drake Bell, whose life has only gotten worse every single year since he starred in Drake and Josh. In 2014, approximately 7 years after the show came to an end, Drake Bell announced that he was filing for bankruptcy, causing a foreclosure on his $2 million mansion. 1 year later, in 2015, he'd be jailed for 4 days as a result of driving under the influence. However, the real drama didn't begin until mid-2020, when his ex-girlfriend would upload a video on TikTok, making some pretty severe accusations.
Imagine the worst type of verbal abuse you could ever imagine, and that was what I got. It then turned into physical, hitting, throwing, everything. At the pinnacle of it, he dragged me down the stairs of our house in Los Feliz. My face hit every step on the way down.
Drake Bell would defend himself by stating, I never Jesus abused my ex-girlfriend or did so many Christ. Of the other things Melissa falsely claimed on her TikTok video. Unfortunately, we both called each other terrible names, as often happens when couples are breaking up, but that is it. Although this response most certainly didn't put an end to the drama, as there was even bigger trouble just around the corner. An article titled Drake Bell's Alleged Victim Accuses Him of Grooming explained that he was embroiled in a legal battle for engaging in a relationship with a 15-year-old girl back in 2017. Things became even worse when footage of the trial was uploaded to YouTube.
How do you plead to count two, disseminating matter harmful to juveniles, first degree misdemeanor.
Think of the edit that was like had like the laugh track and shit on it. Okay, that's I'm sorry, it was in my brain. It was like this, whatever. Moving on.
Guilty.
Let the record reflect, defendant has pled guilty. The court accepts that plea.
And while he would plead guilty to child endangerment, Drake Bell would then take to his Instagram to insinuate that he hadn't done anything wrong.
Lifesaver gummies.
If these claims were remotely true, my situation would be very different. I would not be here at home with my wife and my son.
Despite finishing by stating that he was at home with his wife, this relationship would last only one more year. As in January 2023, on top of everything that had
Janet von Schmeling
already happened, Drake Bell announced that he was also getting a divorce. Considering he's acted in only 2 productions since 2020, it's safe to say that Drake Bell's reputation is pretty much finished, although he's not the only Nickelodeon actor with a spot in this video, as the life of a man-
My name is fine! Warwick Badminton, that's not a bad name, bro. The name was von Schmeling. Right, that is literally a stupid name.
The Bynes has descended.
It just sounds like straight up like fucking Candy Saga. Like fucking, it sounds like a princess name or some shit. Vanellope von Sweets or some Wreck-It Ralph type fucking name.
First version of hell. Despite having one of the most famous faces throughout the 2000s, Amanda Bynes would announce her retirement from acting in 2010, stating that being an actress isn't as fun as it may seem. If I don't love something anymore, I stop doing it. I don't love acting anymore, so I've stopped doing it. I know 24 is a young age to retire, but you heard it here first. She'd go on to state that the retirement was because I literally couldn't stand my appearance in Easy A and I didn't like my performance. I was absolutely convinced that I needed to stop acting after seeing it. However, this is where things began to go downhill rapidly. In 2012, 2 years after retiring, she was charged with driving under the influence and hit and run on two separate occasions. 2 years after this, she'd be charged with driving under the influence again, with her court appearance displaying a significant physical decline from just 2 years prior.
Is that on purpose? Do they show up looking like this in court to make him, like, get a less sentence? Or you think she just... What?
Physical decline from just 2 years prior. In the process, Amanda would take to Twitter to call Michelle and Barack Obama ugly before stating that she and her parents were no longer speaking, which accompanied some absolutely wild accusations about her father, including the statement that he had put a microchip in her brain. After she'd also set fire to a driveway, Amanda was put in a mental hospital, after which her parents were given legal ownership over her $5 million estate, as Amanda has been spending large amounts of her savings. It has been reported that she's recently made extensive purchases as gifts from jewelry stores such as Cartier for strangers. Amanda Bynes was diagnosed with bipolar disorder and would attempt to get her life back on track by enrolling in fashion school. However, she was kicked out only 10 months later for showing up high and arguing with her classmates. In 2018, people assumed that she was back to her normal self as Amanda showed up in magazines looking like this. However, within a year, she'd gotten face tattoos and checked into Alcoholics Anonymous, where she'd meet her new boyfriend who, according to Amanda, had just as many problems as her. In October 2022, she'd make another attempt at fixing her life by enrolling in cosmetic school, yet only 5 months later, in March 2023, she was sent to a mental hospital once again, as she was found roaming the streets of Los Angeles without any clothes on. Then there was Orlando Brown, whose role...
Oh my god, this guy! Damn, they fucked him up, bro.
Roller's Eddie Thomas on That's So Raven ended with an equally terrible life. After the show came to an end in 2007, Orlando began to focus on music, during which his life was kept fairly private until he'd enter news headlines approximately 9 years later. Between February and March 2016, Brown was arrested on two separate occasions on charges of domestic violence, obstruction.
It's literally domestic violence, drug abuse. It's literally the two things. Why?
Of justice, drug possession with the intent to sell, and possession of contraband in jail.
Why is it all that?
In February 2016, cops claimed he struck his then girlfriend in the parking lot of a police station and was found by officers to be in possession of methamphetamine. Orlando was given a notice to appear.
That's gonna happen to you too when you get too famous, bro. That's not how I get any more famous than this, bro. It's all downhill. It's all downhill from here, buddy. Hey, nice fucking optimistic thinking, but it's all downhill from here, bro.
In court, yet he'd instead flee to Las Vegas, where he was caught by bounty hunters.
You left California. It's a felony when you flee.
He did the come on, bro.
Instead flee to Las Vegas, where he was caught by bounty hunters.
You left California.
What?
It's a felony when you flee. What are you doing here then, brother? You got a warrant for your arrest.
After which things only became worse. A video was released of Orlando being kicked out of a friend's house after lasting only a week in rehab, which was followed by his appearance on the Dr. Phil show, during which he'd state that he'd been so...
What the fuck? He turned into a lizard? What are those eyes?
Which is followed by his appearance on the Dr. Phil show, during which he'd state that he'd been sober for 4 years, despite clearly being under the influence on the show.
I'm 4 years sober for a reason. I just now got out of rehab. I just now got out of an ER. I'm not doing no more time away from my kids other than I need you.
As a result of this episode, Orlando would return to rehab and get clean before discussing his experience on the No Jumper podcast.
I had 2 year binge of something that I should have never, ever indulged in.
Meth?
Yes, those situations, man, they will never happen again based off of the fact that where I'm trying to go.
And while he'd end his statement by stating that those situations will never happen again, Orlando was back in the news approximately 7 months later in December 2022 after threatening a family member with a hammer. He's currently undertaking a psychiatric assessment to see if he's eligible for pleading insanity. Yet the most tragic story of child fame with...
I don't know why you'd want to plead insanity. Bro, if you plead insanity, that's got to be worse for you, surely. Like, you're going into a fucking mental asylum. If you're not actually insane and you plead insanity, like...
The most tragic story of child fame without a doubt comes from Judy Garland, who played Dorothy Gale in The Wizard of Oz at the age of 16. Whilst filming the movie, she was prescribed amphetamines to keep up with the production's grueling schedule.
For real? She was straight up just given meth? Like, to act? That was a different time, man. Surely we're not doing that these days.
As well as barbiturates to help her sleep when the day was finally over. The studio also required Judy to stay incredibly thin, feeding her nothing but soup and lettuce leaves whilst on set, which she'd explained led to a poor self-image.
Fucking
By the time The Wizard of Oz was finished, she was being prescribed amphetamines from 4 different doctors to keep her weight down and her mood up, although this lifestyle began to catch up to her.
Drugs, getting up late, coming in late.
That doesn't make sense to me. How little? Like, you're moving around so much. Like, you're literally, like, acting, moving around. Like, how do you need that many amphetamines to stay? Like, how much do you have to be eating? My brain isn't calculating it.
...to work, and it turned into a nightmare for everybody concerned.
She'd be fired from 3 different movies for intoxication and was constantly in the news for being completely broke. Her kids stated that the family couldn't even afford food at times, which
That's
accompanied angry
insane.
Slurred messages about being paid for work.
These weren't delusions. She was broke when she recorded this, and not movie star down to my last Rolls Royce broke, homeless broke, no money to buy food broke.
By the time Judy Garland was in her 40s, she looked about 15 years older, had been divorced 5 different times, and was performing in a New York bar for $100 per night. While Judy Garland maintained that she had never done anything wrong in her entire life,
the only mistake I ever did, the only harm I ever did was sing Over the Rainbow.
She would die of an overdose at the age of 47, on the exact same drug that she was prescribed during The Wizard of Oz, with her estate being worth a measly $40,000.
That's wild. The Tin Man face paint had lead in it and literally poisoned the actor. All the actors had it rough and were permanently scarred with makeup. The fake snow they used in the movie was asbestos. Bro, what the fuck? Sparkles and champagne.
VIP my section, royalty looking sexy, you know that. Oil, I love you.
I love you too, man. Thank you so much for the 37 months, Creator B. What the fuck? That's insane. You in 3 years. I don't even know where I'm going to be in 3 years, bro. I don't look forward like that. Alright, stop linking this guy, please. Adios.
Shit, I don't even know. Like, I can't even tell you that. Like,
Putin, you dirty little cunt. You're a war criminal. You're gonna get done for kidnapping.
Oil smiling coconut happy, yo handsome.
Oh. So, watch this.
Thug shaker now, thug shaker now, thug shaker now.
Bro, I'm not gonna react to force him reacting. Thug shaker now, thug shaker now. You want me to react? To force him reacting to low tier god.
Thanks for the joke.
Okay, man.
Love you, oil. Your dreams make me happy.
Oh, thank you, man. Harp the Ruby. Thanks so much for the five. Thanks for the 5 months. Thank you, man. Thanks for 7 months. Jib Git. Thank you. And Backup. Thanks for 28 months, mate. Thank you. Thank you very much, boys.
Ignore the construction. I'm rebuilding my mansion. You'll see when it's done, we'll do an episode of Cribs. I had to get this area here. I bought my neighbor's house. I had to construct a specific area for the Bugatti. Anyway, that's all gonna be lit up and shit, Bugatti logos. Broke boys don't know. Listen, I recently posted a question on Twitter asking, would you rather have sex with a transsexual, which is a legitimate 10, or a woman, which is a legitimate 1? And everyone's sitting there clicking woman, 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 because they think they're going to be gay if they do anything else. But they're not actually thinking about the question. I am so smart. I operate on so many levels higher than the average man. You people are not thinking about the question. When I say a 1 and a 10, I mean Megan Fox with a dick. That's the tranny. Or Hulk Hogan with a pussy.
What am I listening to? What the fuck am I listening to? Bro, this guy.
This is the question I'm asking. Megan Fox or Hulk Hogan? So you're thinking, well, I don't want to be gay, so I just clicked the girl, the number 1, did it? You're going to fuck Hulk Hogan? Okay, yeah, there's a pussy, but he's got mustache and muscles and shit. He's all hairy.
What?
Pretty gay to me. That sounds pretty gay. I don't care if it's a pussy. That is gay. With Megan Fox, okay, he's got a dick, but maybe you can, like...
Bro, what? What?
Out the way. I'm still Megan Fox. You know what I'm saying? At least she's small and shit. You can get your hand around her neck. Mess her up. You ain't messing up Hulk Hogan. Hulk Hogan's gonna mess you up. So this is the question I'm asking. You need to operate on a higher plane. Think about this. This is important. This is cultural. This affects the world we now live in. What is straight? What is gay? It's all a big sliding spectrum, isn't it? Because if you're gonna sit here and go, oh, no, it's gay to bang Megan Fox with a dick, I counter that argument. It's gay to bang Hulk Hogan with a pussy. So which one is
okay. Okay, man. Yo, all right. Okay. Thanks for the link, man. Thanks for the link. Smartest looting citizen. Bro, he has to be closeted, right? Like, he gotta be. I don't say there's anything wrong with it. I'm just like, just say it. Just sad lately. That's it. Nothing else. I can fix you, bro. Bro, I wonder what Andrew Tate thinks about XQC. Is he a 9? Is he a 1 or a 10?
I will shoot you niggas. I'm not fucking around.
Okay.
What's the most attractive piece of clothing a girl can wear?
I ain't even gonna lie to you. I say some rain boots with some yoga pants and a bucket hat, an emo.
Fucking Coraline? What?
And a bucket hat, an emo dog collar.
So you're asking for a lot of things.
Yeah. Oh, with the arm sleeve, like they finna go play some sports or some basketball.
If you saw a girl that was dressed of this attire right now, what would you do?
I go, I low-key go crazy, but I mean, not too crazy, you know. I just go say, what's up, slide her DMs and try to get at that and see what's good with the badoonka.
Okay, man. I'm gonna blow the White House. It's not even funny anymore. Just stop linking it, please. It's not funny anymore.
The Wizard of Oz is one of the most iconic films in the history of cinema. According to the Library of Congress, it's the single most watched film of all time. Oh, this is the video he's talking about? Very few artistic works from the 1930s have managed to persist within the public consciousness. But even now, 82 years later, most of you watching know exactly who these characters are.
Far yeah, that's less classic. Known,
however, are the people behind these characters. Principal photography for The Wizard of Oz lasted from October 1938 to March 1939.
Chat, if the movie's in color, how come these pictures are in black and white?
During these five...
Was the movie originally in color? It was, right? Shut the fuck up. Oh my god, I'm asking a question. Just answer it. You don't have to be a cunt when I'm asking a question, bro. Like, why can't you just be like, Zoil... this is when colored cameras were just invented, so not everyone had one. This picture was used taking a black and white photo, as colored photos were very expensive to produce, or some shit like that. Like, why can't you just type that, bro? Why can't you just say some shit like that instead of calling me an idiot? Like, holy fuck.
5 months, the stars of the movie were subject to some of the most horrendous conditions in the history of the American film industry. When it was all said and done, not a single character who set off down the yellow brick road left the land of Oz unscathed.
Private drought, even harder than England, rural America is in a desperate plight.
That's not to say that things were much better back home in Kansas.
You can't say that and stop playing Animal Crossing music, man. What the fuck?
That's not to say that things were much better back home in Kansas. The 1930s were a period of major turmoil and hardship for the American public. The Great Depression ravaged almost every sector of the economy. While most American industries were struggling, the film industry was booming. To escape from the dread of everyday life, most Americans sought refuge in the cinema. Nowadays, about 1 in 10 Americans have gone to the movies in the past week. In the 30s, however, it was not uncommon for half of all Americans to pay a weekly visit to the theater. Hollywood was in the midst of its golden age, a period where studios had unparalleled influence over the industry. During this time, the top 8 studios controlled 95% of America.
Which ones of these are still alive today? That's still alive, that's still alive, that's still alive, that's still alive, that's still alive. I don't even know what these two are, though. All of these are? Wait, I've never heard of United Artists or RKO Pictures, Radio Pictures. MGM? Oh, shit.
American cinema, and no studio was more illustrious than MGM. They were the studio widely considered to provide audiences with the biggest stars and the grandest spectacle. MGM smoked the rest of Hollywood with its unmatched financial and critical success. Across the 30s, MGM films accounted for nearly a third of the nominees for Best Picture, and nearly three-quarters of the total profits generated by all 8 major studios. MGM's dominance over Hollywood was due in large part to the strong leadership of its chief executive, Louis B. Mayer, who, in 1937, was the highest-paid man in America. 1937 also saw the release of one of the most groundbreaking films ever made, and one of the most successful films of the time to not come out of the MGM system. That year, Walt Disney would release his first animated feature
Snow
film,
White.
Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. The film was an immersive
fantasy unlike
anything audiences had ever seen.
No, I have.
And by the following year, had become the highest grossing film to date.
No, I have, never mind.
Snow White's record-breaking success inspired MGM to produce a spectacular fantasy of their own. In 1938, the studio bought out the rights to L. Frank Baum's popular children's novel, The Wonderful Wizard of Oz, and the rest was history. A history that some members of the cast and crew wished they could forget. Unlike Snow White, The Wizard of Oz was entirely live action, which presented a series of challenges while attempting to transform fantasy into reality. One of the most iconic scenes in all of cinema is Dorothy waking up in the Land of Oz and the film transitioning from sepia to color. The official coloring method used to develop the film was Technicolor, which required heavy exposure due to the process of splitting the image into different color channels. As a result, the Oz set required an exorbitant amount of lighting, so much so that the temperature on stage often surpassed 100 degrees Fahrenheit.
Holy fuck!
The heat was suffocating, and stagehands frequently had to be carried off stage after fainting. The set lighting was so intense that some actors even claimed to suffer permanent vision damage. The exhaustion suffered from the oppressive heat was only magnified by the arduous production schedule. For 6 days a week, the actors walked into the studio at 4 a.m. and didn't leave until 7 p.m. A significant part of each actor's day was dedicated to the meticulous preparation and removal of their costumes.
Bro, the movie wasn't that
good. The Scarecrow, Tin Man, and Cowardly Lion are one of the most recognizable trios in fiction. All three characters were brought to life by the skilled design of makeup artist Jack Dawn. While the costumes presented an impeccable external appearance, conditions weren't so pleasant on the inside. Every morning as the Scarecrow, Ray Bolger would have to spend an hour getting his latex and plastic mask painstakingly glued to his face, and every evening he would spend an hour getting it removed. The mask completely covered his facial pores, meaning that he was physically unable to sweat while wearing it. One could only imagine how it must have felt to wear that thing for 15 hours a day.
But Ray Bolger
didn't have to imagine. For 22 weeks, it was his reality. By the time filming was complete, the repeated applications of the mask left Bolger with permanent grooves around his mouth and chin, but considering what happened to some of the other actors, he may have gotten off easy. The Tin Man was played by Buddy Ebsen for about 9 days. That's how long he lasted during filming until he was hospitalized from a severe reaction to the Tin Man's metallic makeup. Ebsen's silver face paint was made out of aluminum powder, powder that would eventually coat the inside of his lungs, nearly asphyxiating him. As Ebsen sat bedridden under an oxygen tent in the hospital, the studio could not have given him less sympathy. Producer Mervyn LeRoy repeatedly phoned the hospital, angrily insisting that Ebsen return to the set. After 2 weeks out of action, the studio replaced Ebsen with Jack Haley. Much like Pete Best getting cut from the Beatles, Buddy Ebsen would end up becoming one of the unluckiest men in show business. Not only was he unceremoniously fired from what would have been the biggest role of his career, the incident left him with chronic bronchitis. Jack Haley managed to avoid a catastrophic reaction to the aluminum makeup, but it still gave him a severe eye infection that forced him out of work for days. The rest of the suit was so stiff that it rendered Haley unable to sit down or lie down during filming. In order to rest in between takes, he was forced to lean on a reclining board. But despite all the complications it caused, the Tin Man costume may have still been preferable to that of the Cowardly Lion.
Shut up, why didn't they just use something different after, you know, the first guy was hospitalized? Why didn't they just like, you know, hey, how about we don't use aluminum powder? This guy's literally in the hospital in a fucking oxygen tent. Huh? They didn't have anything different. Should have used like lead or something instead of aluminum.
It was compared to carrying around a mattress. The bulk of the costume consisted of a 60-pound lion
hide. I'm kidding.
A real
lion hide. Bro, I didn't think it's a 30s.
Combined with additional padding, some estimates put the weight of the full costume at 100 pounds. Burt Lahr would become drenched in sweat after just a few minutes, and he would frequently have to take off the suit between shots to avoid exhaustion. The prosthetic mask covering his face didn't allow him to fully open his mouth, forcing him to consume all of his on-set meals through a straw. Halfway through production, Lahr gave in and sacrificed an additional hour each day in the makeup chair so that he could eat solid food at lunch. As someone who was known by his peers to be a hypochondriac, Burt Lahr was in near constant agony. But by far the worst costume-related accident during the whole shoot happened to Margaret Hamilton, better known as the Wicked Witch. Nowadays, there are lots of ways to make someone look green, but in 1938, the only tried-and-true method used by Hollywood makeup artists was copper paint. Of course, is toxic when ingested by humans. This was known back then, but the studio showed no restraint in applying the copper concoction directly to Hamilton's face and hands. Towards the end of production, Hamilton realized that the constant application of the witch's makeup had tinted her skin green, an effect that lingered for months after the job. Wearing the makeup on set was a constant struggle. Once it was on, Hamilton was unable to touch anything without staining it and required assistance to perform the most basic of tasks. But the day-to-day struggles of the makeup would pale in comparison to the accident she suffered on December 23, 1938. When departing Munchkinland, Hamilton was scripted to exit the scene in a fiery cloud of smoke. The first attempt at the stunt went flawlessly, but director Victor Fleming wanted to get a few extra takes for insurance. On the fourth attempt, the pyrotechnics were ignited too early, causing Hamilton to be engulfed in flames. The accident resulted in second-degree burns on the whole right side of her face. The skin on her right hand was entirely scalded off. But before Hamilton could even receive medical attention, she had to slowly and excruciatingly have the copper makeup removed from her freshly burned skin with rubbing alcohol. Margaret Hamilton would spend the next 6 weeks in the hospital before returning to the set. On her very first day back, she was scheduled for the skywriting.
I bet they were calling out the fucking hospital telling her to hurry up, fucking recovering as well. Fucking hell, man.
On her very first day back, she was scheduled for the skywriting scene, another stunt involving pyrotechnics. Hamilton adamantly refused to put herself anywhere near fire again and threatened to walk out of the production right then and there. Since the project was nearing completion at that point, the studio acquiesced, and the scene was completed using Hamilton's stunt double, Betty Danko. While filming that very scene, the smoke pipe underneath the broomstick exploded, and Danko was violently flung from the installation.
Bro!
The explosion was caused by the special effects crew coating the pipe with asbestos. Another toxic substance once thought to be an all-purpose wonder material, asbestos was also used in Ray Bulger's scarecrow suit as well as the snow in the poppy field scene.
They're dead! Oh, bro! Bro!
Unusual weather we're having, ain't it?
Betty Danko was hospitalized for 11 days with internal damage from the explosion, as well as a 2-inch deep gash on her leg, that would never fully heal. It was a hefty toll for a gig last year and just over $800. The long-term health effects of Margaret Hamilton were far less
than thanks for the 11 months, man. Thank you.
Known. What is known is that she would go on to develop Alzheimer's later in her life, a condition that has been linked to copper poisoning. In total, 6 performers on The Wizard of Oz faced some kind of serious physical trauma. Not even Toto left the set intact. However, after enough time had passed, many of the actors could look back on the whole ordeal as a bunch of amusing war stories. Most physical ailments are only temporary. Mental ailments, on the other hand, tend to stick with you for life. And out of everyone in the Land of Oz, perhaps none suffered a worse fate than the star of the show, Judy Garland. She was without a doubt one of the most talented performers of the 20th century. Her portrayal of Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz has served as an enduring symbol of youth and innocence.
Fuck,
and man. Even though she was never imprisoned by a brutal costume like the other actors, the studio paid no less scrutiny to her appearance. Since the character of Dorothy was envisioned as a prepubescent girl, the then 17-year-old Garland had to constantly wear a tight corset to hide her more mature figure. But that was merely one aspect of the studio's efforts to keep Judy thin. Garland was placed on a shoestring diet, one that would not provide her with enough energy to complete the arduous filming days. To compensate, the studio kept Garland on a steady intake of amphetamines to keep her working long into the day.
Holy fuck,
the amphetamines
bro.
Subsequently necessitated the use of barbiturates to prevent Garland from exhausting herself. Years later, she claimed that during some periods, she would only sleep 4 hours every 3 days. The fact that she was able to perform as well as she did under these conditions is nothing short of astonishing. By the end of production, Garland was addicted to both drugs, an addiction that would last for the rest of her life. It certainly didn't help that her time as a child star directly contributed to deep-rooted psychological problems. Despite her brilliance as a performer, Garland was always encumbered by major esteem issues. The insecurities began when a 14-year-old Garland overheard the MGM executives referring to her as a fat little pig. This moment completely devastated her self-image and manifested itself as an unobtainable standard of perfection that she spent her whole life chasing.
Bro, guys, are you not hearing what they're saying in the show about how it destroyed her and then you're gonna at me? Bro, what is wrong with you?
And even though she would wind
what
up becoming one
guys?
Of the greatest performers
Damn,
ever,
bro.
In her mind, it was never
Man,
good
you'll
enough.
You'll be ashamed of yourself.
In many ways, Judy Garland was the first tragic child star, an archetype that has sadly become much more common in modern times. Clinical psychiatrist John Linden encountered many such patients while practicing in the Los Angeles area. He observed that premature stardom resulted in many child actors forming severe identity issues. They tended to report a feeling of profound emptiness when they weren't performing, as if they were marionettes whose true selves lacked any sort of meaning. The reason so many young stars end up on the downward spiral is that many fail to develop any sense of individual identity. Some attempt to fill this void with sex, drugs, and alcohol, but it's often no match for the constant anxiety of never really understanding who you are. There exists a tragic irony between Judy Garland and Dorothy. A character who wanted nothing more than to find joy and comfort in a wayward world. Unlike Dorothy, however, Judy Garland never made it over the rainbow. On June 22, 1969, Judy Garland was found dead of an overdose on her bathroom floor. She was just 47 years old. In the years leading up to her death, her increasingly erratic downfall was treated by the media as some sort of morbid spectacle. The American public seemed unable to reconcile how she could have possibly been anyone other than the innocent farm girl from Kansas.
Damn, bro.
Hollywood has the remarkable ability to make the wildest parts of our imagination come to life, but the magic of crafting immersive fantasies comes with a very real dark side. Oftentimes, it's easy for studios to lose sight of the real-life human beings at their disposal and to end up treating them as, well, marionettes. It would be easy to look back at all the trauma from The Wizard of Oz and chalk it up to a product of its time. Back then, studios could just get away with all of it because if any actor fought back, they would be blacklisted from the industry. But still,
they straight up just got blacklisted.
Even after the studio's iron grip over the industry was broken and actors gained more leverage over their careers, it would be naive to suggest that much has changed in Hollywood. The inner workings of the film industry have always been an enigma. The history of Hollywood is smeared with talented people guilty of terrible
that guy,
things.
Jesus.
Very rarely do we ever get to discover what truly goes on behind the big green curtain. Out of every scandal that does come to light, we can only imagine what remains in the dark. In the business of telling the biggest stories possible, the smaller stories often get left behind. For 22 weeks in 1938 and 1939, six of Hollywood's most talented actors were practically tortured, with many of them experiencing
Yo, Nim! Nim, thanks for rain, man. You had a good day of work, brother. Thank you very much.
Damage to their bodies and minds.
Welcome, Namorous.
The result was one of the single greatest artistic works of the
Watching a video on The Wizard of Oz right now. Unfortunately, it's at the end, but hey, welcome, Namorous. Welcome.
The century. Show the Wizard cats. Of Oz was He's the defining right career achievement for every single person who worked on it.
I don't want to wake
their
him up.
Their suffering had directly contributed to the most beloved film of a generation. It's tempting to dismiss everything you've heard today as an exploitative cash grab from greedy media tyrants. But for MGM, it was never that simple. In 1939, MGM released 41 films in total, premiering a new movie once every 9 days on average. At this time, the studio had no shortage of revenue. What they coveted instead was prestige.
How did they make that many movies
so
quick?
Every year, MGM would earmark one production as their prestige film, a project that was never intended to turn a profit, but one that existed for the simple purpose of flexing the cinematic might of the studio. From its very conception, The Wizard of Oz was designed as a monument to the single most dominant empire in the history of the film industry. 35 years after the film's release, toy executive Marty Abrams was conducting market research on local children and found that 80% recognized the characters of Oz. Today, memorabilia attached to these characters now sell for millions at auction. Over the years, the performers who brought these characters to life have gradually faded from public memory, their sacrifices ultimately forgotten. Dorothy, Scarecrow, Tin Man, Cowardly Lion, and the Wicked Witch have managed to outlive them. Such is the ultimate destiny of people in show business. Actors are tragically temporary. Eventually, only the characters remain. Today, it may seem unfathomable that our most popular and celebrated actors will inevitably meet the same fate. But at the end of the day, it is art, not the artist, which stands the test of time. Despite the turmoil suffered by the actors on the set of Oz, one has to wonder if any of them ever regretted it.
Way.
4,500 years ago, the ancient Egyptians completed the Great Pyramid of Giza,
okay.
A structure so remarkably ambitious that it would stand as the tallest building on Earth until the Middle Ages.
That is like a fucking
For millennia, archaeologists found
bro.
It inconceivable that it could have been constructed by any other means than a massive workforce of slave labor. The pyramid defied our expectations to such an extent that some people believe it had to have resulted from supernatural or extraterrestrial influence. However, recent archaeological studies have uncovered a truth that is somehow even more unbelievable. The vast majority of people who built the Great Pyramid were volunteers. The ancient Egyptians risked life and limb to participate in something greater than themselves. Their reward for 20 years of deadly backbreaking labor is that we still talk about them today, long after everything they knew and loved ceased to exist. What would you be willing to sacrifice if it meant you could live forever? Since the dawn of civilization, mankind has sought the secret to immortality. We can only wonder if science or religion will ever help us achieve eternal life. But at the very least, art can get us pretty damn close.
For nearly 40 years, this story has been giving faithful service to the young and hard, and time has been powerless to put its... Yes. Hollywood, way... That was a good video, man. That was a good video. Damn. That was really fucking good, actually. What did you think, chat? Why does this video keep fucking popping? Can I, like, get rid of it for my shit? Can I just feel like I'm not interested? Because it keeps popping up, bro. It doesn't go away. It won't go. And now I've clicked on it. It's probably going to keep coming up. Why did I click on it, man? I wonder if there's been a new cut chat. I love those videos. The button pressing videos. I think I already saw this one. What about on trending? Anything new in the world? Anything new in the world right now? Mr. Beast, 100 assassins versus 10 real cops.
I hired these 10 real police officers to bring...
Oh my god, what? Mr. Beast Gaming, what the fuck?
Protect me from 100 assassins. If you keep me alive.
Do these videos do good, chat? I mean, it's on fucking trending. It's got to be. Oh my god!
For the next 30 minutes, I'll give each of you $10,000.
Yo!
Let's go, baby! But if at any point I die, the assassins get the 100 grand.
Oh my fucking god, man. There's got to be something else in here. There's got to be something interesting in here. What's going on in the world? Blue Beetle, that shit looked ass. I'm not going to be watching that. I deep fried steak using Papa John's garlic sauce and this happened.
If you live in the United States, you are familiar with Papa John's pizza. They claim to have the best ingredients because it makes a better pizza. But
I'm going to be honest, for me, it's Domino's, Pizza Hut, then Papa John's. I don't like Papa John's.
Honestly, that's not why I order Papa John's pizza. I always get it because of this, their garlic sauce. Now, if you never had this, let me tell you something. This thing is addicting. I can eat this whole thing just by myself. Ew. Especially when you dunk your pizza in it, it's just fantastic.
That ain't sauce, bro. That's straight oil. Where the fuck is the sauce
at? Dunk your pizza in it, it's just fantastic. And let's try to settle a debate. Who makes the best pizza?
We're about to interview some people.
Mr. Leonardis, how are you?
What is that?
Do not make fun of my microphone.
Google, in this nice studio, you're gonna have that as a mic?
Who makes the best pizza?
Domino's. No question.
True.
I like their crust.
True.
His voice crazy. Who makes the best pizza?
Dude, Domino's makes the best pizza hand down, okay? Listen, if I know anything, it's about fucking food, right? You gotta trust me on this one. You have to trust me on this one, chat. Domino's makes the best pizza.
Papa John's, for sure. Domino's, stop seasoning your crust. It makes no sense.
David, who makes the best pizza?
I gotta go with the sleeper, Little Caesars. $5 for a whole pie? That's the same price you got that mic for.
Wow, roasted again. Who makes the best pizza?
I would have to say Domino's.
Nick, who makes the best pizza?
It's Papa John's for sure.
Wrong.
2K, who makes the best pizza?
I'm Cuban, so I'm gonna go with Ray's Pizza, but if we're going straight up American...
The fuck is Ray's Pizza, bro?
Papa John's number one. The sauce is the best part. The garlic butter dip.
I have to agree because this sauce is what makes the pizza great for me. Now, since it's really good with pizza, I'm wondering how is it going to taste with some steaks? I mean, it has to be good, right? Well, we're about to find out right now.
Domino's ain't pizza. Okay, what is it then, buddy? No, Van Dazzle. What is a Domino? What is Domino's pizza if it ain't pizza? What is it? Garbage. Okay. For what? Okay. Pizza can be garbage if you throw it away. So is it? It's still pizza though. Domino's is good. Okay. This is my opinion of Domino's. It's not great. Okay. You can get the best pizza ever if you go to like an actual Italian restaurant or whatever. Right. But Domino's is consistently good. It always comes out the same, bro. It always comes out the same, so you know what you're expecting. You know what you're expecting.
However, the first thing we need to do is to acquire a good amount of it. And that is one of the reasons I have a very good nephew. I had to send him out to buy several from...
I'm sorry for pausing. Domino's is $25. Bro, ordering from anywhere costs more money. You can make a pizza for like fucking 50p if you make it by yourself. But you're not going to sit there fucking making the dough and fucking putting the sauce on it. And you're not going to spend your time doing that, are you?
For us, we're talking about 50 sauces. And that got me thinking, maybe we should just make our own Papa John's sauce at home. So the first thing we had to do is to find the right butter. When I took a closer look at the ingredients of the Papa John's garlic sauce, it is not butter at all. I mean, the main ingredient is soybean oil. And on the barbecue circuit, there is one thing that we use quite often. That would be the Parkway squeezable butter. And if
that
you take a look at the first ingredient,
that ain't butter, bro.
Even when I spread it out on a plate, you can see that it has the same exact consistency. So yeah, this is very similar to what Papa John's uses. However, the next thing is to go ahead and find out what type of spices. It was quite simple, because it's a combination of garlic powder and onion powder. Mix, 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 and there you have it, Papa John's secret recipe for garlic sauce. Now, I'm not quite sure if this is exactly how they do it, but I'll tell you one thing, it tastes identical. However, for today's experiment, we're gonna be using the real thing. I'm talking about over 50 of these little sauces. Now, this is way more expensive than making at home. However, using the real deal will give us a better result. So after opening all of them, I set them on a container. Whoa. Now I have a good amount of Papa John's garlic sauce ready to be used. Good. Talking about that, that I'll be doing so in these three beautiful steaks. As you can see, they are New York strip. They're also 1.5 inches thick and perfect for today's experiment. The first thing to do is to go ahead and
you're
have
ruining
them seasoned.
Such a beautiful
for that, I kept
steak,
it real simple.
Man.
A good amount of salt followed by freshly ground black pepper and garlic powder. Once that was done, they are now ready. And if you've been watching my channel for a while, you know we cannot just eat steaks by itself. Usually, whenever the guys are eating pizza in the studio, they always order something else. And this time, they wanted this. It's called Chicken Parmesan Papa Bites. Now, I'll be honest with you, they don't look that appetizing, but my guys like it. And today, I'm going to show you my version of this. And just by the looks, you can tell that it's going to be better. And here's how I made it. The first thing to do is to spread out some pizza dough. If you want my pizza dough recipe, it will be on the link in the description. Then, I went ahead and made a marinara sauce. For that, it's pretty simple. Into a pan with olive oil, I combined garlic and shallots. Cook that for a little bit, then add added crushed tomatoes. Let that simmer. Once it was done, then I seasoned it with a little bit of salt, let it reduce a little bit, and my marinara sauce was done. It does not get any easier than that. So after adding a good amount of marinara sauce, I went ahead and added some chicken. Now this is shredded rotisserie chicken. So once that was added, I went ahead and added a good amount of mozzarella cheese. I mean, you gotta be generous with it. Now you wanna spread everything nicely, cut the
this
pizza
man knows
dough
how
edges
to cook,
out,
chat.
And start rolling the whole thing. Once done, cut out the final edge and start cutting them into small
knows.
Little pieces. I highly recommend setting them down on a parchment paper. And if you want it to look golden brown, definitely give it an egg wash. Because once you have done so to all of them, in the oven it goes in the bake setting at 450 degrees Fahrenheit for about 20 minutes. Once they come out, they should be looking nice and golden brown. And to add even more flavor, go ahead and add that garlic butter sauce from Papa John's. Set them down on a nice serving plate. And to finish it, just add a little bit of parsley for color. And this is today's side dish. It smells incredible. And let's be real, it looks 10 times better than the one that you can buy from Papa John's. This should be pairing up perfectly with our steak.
That's gonna be like 5 times
that,
more fucking unhealthy.
It, the first thing we need to do is to put everything into the cast iron skillet.
How are you gonna call this sauce? This ain't no sauce, bro.
In order to deep
sauce,
fry it, the first thing
we
need to do is to put
what
everything into
that?
The cast iron skillet. Then outside I went. The first thing to do was to go ahead and melt the whole thing. Under high heat, that's quite easy to do. And this is where I ran into a problem. Because as soon as it's starting to get up to temperature, it was starting to foam up, meaning that it was gonna boil over. So the deep frying idea was not gonna happen. So I decided to go with the best second thing, which is to come feed the steak. You wanna keep flipping it as many times as necessary.
Bro, that's boiling it. You're boiling it in butter.
Nice
don't.
And at the same time,
let's not add fucking French words. You're boiling
with it. The garlic sauce. However, you can see that this steak is not getting any crust, and we know that that's not okay. And I mean, take a look at it. It looks sorry. I love steaks, but I cannot eat something that it looks like it was boiled. However, we can fix that
real
quick. Now remember, I have two other steaks to compare as well. So one will be the control. The second one, we're going to be cooking the same exact
so
way
like
as the control. However, in the end, I'll be adding the garlic butter sauce. And the one that was just come feed on the garlic sauce, that one will be getting a nice sear. Because now I say, it is enough talking and it is time to finish up these beautiful steaks. So let's do it.
Oh, this is a good spot now.
Alright everybody, here we got our beautiful
in your
steak,
mouth,
my
son.
Taste tester, and a nice side dish today.
Side dish is pretty nice looking.
Yeah.
It looks delicious.
Hey listen, we got a little experiment. I want to know your honest opinion. Just be as honest as possible with me. Let the audience know if it's good, bad, or ugly, because I'm excited. Are you guys ready?
I'm ready. Steak on the table.
As long as we got steak, we're good to go. Enough talking, let's go for it. Andrew, dig in, please.
Hey, Leo.
Leo, dig in. Ooh. I love
we
it.
We cook it better in the UK, though.
Nice.
Enough UK talking, steak give is it a the go. Best. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Oh.
You can really feel that charcoal flavor.
British
extra,
beef
extra
is the best,
steak
bro.
As well, and just a great pronounced beef flavor on it. This is a perfect steak.
I couldn't have said any better.
That's like a, it's like a Google steak, but on like charcoal steroids.
Yes.
I like that.
That was delicious, but did you guys feel anything different?
Wait, let me check again.
Very good, enough talking, let's go for the second one. Please dig in, guys, let me know. I'm gonna go in. You're very kind, sir.
Angel allowed me the first round, I gotta let him go the second.
I like this respect, I'm not used to this.
There's nothing the British have that is better. You just cap it.
Messed up the order, but we just kept it going.
Boom, there you go.
Damn.
We accept your apology, Google.
Wow.
You just had to say something, Google.
All right, enough talking, let's go for the second one. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
We have three dental in the UK.
It's crazy how much juicier the steak feels, and I feel like a huge wave of just richness that punch you right in the face.
Yeah, I agree 100%. It is extremely creamy as you are as you're taking bites, right?
It's like a silky, creamy, like the oil feel a little bit more creamy.
And it coats your mouth, and it just...
Oh, that was a good video. I actually lost interest. Kay's cooking. Now, this is proper British cooking right here. This is... Oh, God. Chicken meal. Why does it look like it's a 3D render from a video game? It literally looks like it's straight out of like Half-Life or some shit. There's a good amount of, you know, it's chicken. There's no fucking season on it, but I'd eat it. Alright, that was fucking... One more. What has she cooked recently? Small baguettes. The fuck is a fish finger pie? I swear to God, I've never heard of a fish finger pie before. This ain't... okay? How the fuck does he make fish fucking sticks look so disgusting? Dude, these fish fingers, the bird eye fish fingers, are banging. I haven't had them in years. But they're fucking... They're delicious. Those are fucking delicious. I get Americans now saying we put beans on everything. I get it. We don't, okay? But, like, this isn't... this is just stupid. This is fucking stupid. We don't do this shit, alright? We don't put beans on everything. It's not the best British food. I'm about to cook some scrumdiddlyumptious food, bro. I'm gonna do a cooking stream where I cook British staples. I'm gonna cook like a fish pie. Oh, bro, I should do that. I should cook a fish pie. I should cook, what else do we have? Shepherd's pie, stargazy pie, steak and kidney pie. Cornish pasty. Oh, bro, we have so many good foods.
It's
barely fucking cooked. Maybe the fact that they've been fucking drenched in beans and mashed potatoes. Yo, K Conan Digger, thanks so much for the 5 gifted subs, mate. Thank you very much. Boys, put some hot.
Mod stand by. I don't know what the fuck is going on here.
Yo, thanks for 16 months smoking Sherm. Thank you. I can't watch any more of these. I just can't. I can't, man. This isn't the best British cooking. Who's a good cook that's from the UK? Best British food. Oh, here we go. 4 months ago. This is going to show you the best
Welcome
food
Welcome to Watch Mojo UK. And today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 greatest British foods or dishes. For this list, we'll be looking at some classic staples of UK cooking. What's your favourite UK meal and your perfect pudding? Let us know in the comments. Number 10, Toad in the Hole.
Oh, God. It's off to a strong start, aren't we? Oh.
We love our sausages in the UK, whether as part of a breakfast, slapped on a butty, or paired with fluffy potato to create the classic bangers and mash. One traditional sausage dish that still survives today is the humble Toad in the Hole. It's not the most appetizing of names, but otherwise, what's not to like about sausages baked in Yorkshire pudding batter?
The Yorkshire pudding, it goes soggy. A Yorkshire pudding's supposed to be crispy and fluffy, but when you bake the sausages in it, it goes, like, soggy. It's gross.
Simple meal is quick to make, and especially tasty when paired with onion gravy. Toad in the Hole began popping up in the 18th century as a way for poor families to stretch out meagre meat portions. It wasn't always made with sausage. One early recipe calls for pigeon in the hole. But nowadays, it's sausage or nothing. Number 9. Haggis, Neeps and Tatties.
This isn't fair. This really ain't fair, bro. Like, this guy is coughing. We have better food. We have better food. I swear we do. I swear.
Deep stomach stuffed with offal.
What is haggis?
But nowadays it's sauce nothing. Number 9. Haggis, neeps and tatties. A sheep's stomach stuffed with offal, onion and spices might not sound delicious.
Bro, it's got offal in it. You just said you described offal as one of the fucking ingredients.
Offal, onion and spices might not sound delicious, but it's actually pretty good. Haggis can sometimes be found in a full Scottish breakfast, but is most often eaten as part of the
Burns. We don't claim the Scots here in England.
Neeps and tatties, turnips and potatoes are traditionally served alongside the haggis and washed down with a dram of whiskey. Baron's Night celebrates the famous Scots poet,
but should we say the Scots don't claim
us, of Auld Lang Syne, and addressed to a haggis. The latter poem is read over the food at an annual supper, after the haggis has been piped in with great ceremony. It's possibly an acquired taste, but it's hearty fare, well suited to cold winter nights. Number 8. Steak and kidney pie. They may favour sweet pies across the pond, but in the UK, we're all about the savoury. And the meatier, the better. Apple pie and custard is worth a mention too, but honestly, we're more likely to cook up a crumble. Whether you're opting for chicken and mushroom or steak and ale, serve your pie with mash or with chips and don't stint on the
grill. Steak and ale pie is so good.
Pork pie eaten as a snack is one of life's great pleasures.
They're so good.
But steak and kidney is the real classic. The combination of that rich, meaty filling, thick gravy, and golden brown pie crust
is
utterly mouth-watering, especially if the pie is homemade.
Bro, I'm telling you, it don't look that appetizing, but this is like the most rich, tasty, gravy, steaky. Oh, they're so good, bro. The pastry is flaky, buttery. They're so tasty, bro.
Number 7. Trifle. Originating in England, the trifle has had some success as a children's party favorite, but really, it's adults who love this indulgent confection of jelly, fruit, and cream. That might have something to do with the amount of booze it's acceptable to pour into these things. Although the recipe can vary greatly, versions of this layered pudding began making cookery book appearances back in the 16th century. The trifle's glory days may be behind it, but as it's easily rustled up and always looks impressive, we doubt it will disappear anytime soon. In fact, in 2022, a new variation on the dessert, including lemon Swiss roll, white chocolate, and amaretti biscuits, was chosen as the official platinum pudding to commemorate the Queen's Jubilee. Number 6. Shepherd's pie and cottage pie. When it comes to the nation's favourite pies, some of our most beloved are not really pies at all.
There we go.
Shepherd's pie.
Boys,
and cottage
I'm scared.
Pie.
How is this only at 6? Shepherd's pie is at 6. What the fuck's in front of shepherd's pie?
Pie are established family favourites made from mincemeat topped with mashed potato and cooked in the oven.
Beans
Many
and,
of us think of the two
toast.
Pies as interchangeable.
It's What's beans it? On toast, first of all, and beans on toast is pretty fucking good. I'll give it a fucking 5.
Supposedly, shepherd's pie uses lamb, hence the name, while cottage is traditionally made with beef mince. The British cousin of spaghetti bolognese and chili con carne, shepherd's or cottage pie has become a staple for many of us in the UK. However, there is a possibility that it actually originated in France. Number 5.
Don't you dare! Don't you dare say that!
Originated in France.
No, he's fucking lying. Fuck off.
Number 5. Sticky toffee pudding. Compared to some of the distinguished dishes on this list, sticky toffee pudding is a bit of a newfangled invention, coming to popularity in the 1970s.
Yummy.
The Aussies and the Kiwis call it sticky date pudding, but we can claim the recipe as our own. The modern incarnation traces back to a hotel in Cumbria, although one pub in Yorkshire claims they were serving it back in 1907. A good sticky toffee pudding consists of a light, moist sponge made with chopped dates and seasoned with nuts or spices.
That
it's doused
so
in
yum.
Toffee sauce and served with vanilla ice cream or custard. There's no British delicacy
that's
that
pretty fucking good, though. Oh, dude, do you know what I love? Sticky toffee pudding's good. Do you know what's better? Jam roly-poly. You know what's better? Spotted dick. Bro, spotted dick goes so good, bro. Oh, my fucking God. That shit is tasty.
Feels more indulgent. But if you want a quick fix, You can even make it in the microwave.
Bro, that's what it's called. Spotted dick with creamy custard. That's what it's called, bro. Chat, that's what it's fucking called. Let me show you spotted dick. Spotted dick. Look. Oh, God. Okay. Look. Is this TOS? No, it's fine. Look. See, it's like a cake with, like, there's some raisins in it. Oh, bro, it's kind of like a less dense fruit cake. They're good, bro. Oh, I need to click on this.
Number 4, chicken tikka masala.
It's
considered
that by
some as our national dish.
Bro, our national dish is straight up stolen, bro. Our national dish is straight up stolen. Oh my God.
Chicken tikka masala. Considered by some as our national dish.
It's so good though.
Yes, really. This mild chicken curry is Britain's favourite Indian meal.
You can tell it's fucking British because zero spice in it. It's literally the mildest curry you could probably ever fucking make.
It's not really Indian at all. Inspired by butter chicken, it's believed to have been invented back in the 60s by the British South Asian community. Was it the Bangladeshi migrant chefs, the British Pakistanis from Glasgow, or the Indian cook from London with the can of Campbell's
smoking
soup?
Sherm.
Whichever apocryphal tale is the true version, we can safely say that chicken tikka masala was designed to be marketed to Brits. Not too spicy and swimming in gravy.
Not
the
too
tomato
spicy.
And chicken-based dish.
I've never had a chicken tikka curry where my tongue even remotely tingled. There's zero like spice in it whatsoever.
More than a tasty takeaway classic, it's multiculturalism in action. Number 3. A full English breakfast.
Oh, fuck me, you dirty slut. Look how fucking gorgeous that looks.
This is the most important meal of the day.
God.
And there's nothing
Look
more satisfying than when you get the chance to do it properly. No croissants or pancakes for us. Brits traditionally break their fast with a fry up. Your full English should typically include sausages, bacon and eggs, mushrooms, fried bread, fried or grilled tomatoes, black pudding, and maybe a hash brown or two. The Scottish add haggis, white pudding, oat cakes, or tatty scone.
Oh, I somehow muted myself. Those beans look a bit weak. Is that just me? Like, the sauce is too thin. Those have to be like Tesco value. Those ain't Heinz baked beans.
Long time
no
see, mate. I've got a throwback for you. Do you remember playing Ark years ago and telling us about your dad's favorite chicken recipe? Grape flavored chicken. Congrats on all the success also.
Yeah, I do remember that. I do remember that, bro. It was blackcurrant flavored chicken. I remember
the Welsh
that, yeah.
Occasionally include cockles.
Thank you for the 3 pound, man.
And an Ulster fry might be served with soda bread.
What? Okay, so basically, you know how, like, there's orange chicken? Like, orange chicken is a thing, right? Like, it's tasty, it's scrumdiddlyumptious, you get at the restaurant. My dad, like, decided to make food one night, okay? And he was actually a good cook. My dad's a good cook. He had his own catering business and everything, all right? And he decided, you know what? If orange chicken works, why don't I try making blackcurrant chicken? So he got some Robinson's squash and added it to chicken, like, as a sauce? I don't understand, like, what he was doing, okay? But it was fucking disgusting. Is your dad white? No. It was really fucking bad, bro. It was just disgustingly sweet, tart, just, it was gross.
Bread or potato cakes. Whatever part of the UK you hail from, it's widely understood that a fry-up is the food of the gods, a reliable hangover cure, and a great British institution. Number 2, a Sunday roast. Talking of British institutions, let's take a minute to celebrate the traditional Sunday roast.
Bro, I can't
Many
the last
households
I went to a
still
carvery,
sit down
bro.
To a roast dinner on a Sunday afternoon, and pubs do a roaring trade in carveries for Sunday lunch. The Great British Roast is basically a less...
Fuck me, look at that Yorkshire pud! That's illegal, mate. Fucking hell.
The Great British Roast.
Look at that.
Is basically a less fancy version of your classic Christmas dinner. Roasted meat, Yorkshire pudding, roast potatoes ginormous. And veg are your basic components. Gravy and stuffing are recommended, and of course, whatever sauce goes best with your meat of choice. Whether you're tugging into chicken, lamb, or a bit of roast beef, the plates are piled high and
the
soon
fuck is that?
Scraped clean.
Before we begin, we publish new content every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos.
Shh. We've covered
fish and chips as number one. I have to disagree. I genuinely have to disagree. I think fish and chips ain't that good. Like, it's good, but it's overrated.
Breakfast and Sunday dinner, but what about those evenings?
When I would put Cornish pasty as number one. I said it, bro. I think Cornish pasty is number one. Cornish pasty deserves a spot, bro. I said it, bro. I actually said it. I actually believe
just
it.
Just can't be bothered
I believe
to
it,
cook.
Bro.
What about days out by the seaside or Friday nights in front of the telly? That calls for a trip to the chippy. Our beloved fish and chip shops have been here since the 1860s, and they're everywhere you look. Battered fish deep fried in oil, hot chips served with gravy, curry sauce, or lashings of salt and vinegar.
Okay, curry sauce though, okay? If you get actually well-made curry sauce, fuck me. That brings it all together.
More comforting. Traditionally, fish and chips were eaten on a Friday, partly due to the Catholic custom of eschewing meat on that day.
It's not disgusting, it's top 10 UK foods.
There is no bad time to indulge in this iconic combination.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from Watch Mojo UK.
Good one, man. Good one. Well, you're fucking wrong. Coming from Ireland, I can honestly say I can't get enough of any of these dishes. What? Wait, Russell's calling me. Yo. Yoo-hoo. Hello.
Hey, what's up, man?
What's up, baby cakes? How you doing?
Oh, I'm just chilling. What are you doing?
I'm just watching some YouTube videos, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. How you doing?
I'm chilling. I was just bored, so I thought, you know, who's a good person to call right now when I'm bored and I'm lonely? And I thought, oh, hey.
Why not your girlfriend?
Soil's got a lot of viewers.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah. Really? No, no, you're right. Why not my girlfriend? Actually, I just got done talking to her, and she's going out to dinner with her family.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, she's going out to dinner with her family.
Why doesn't she have dinner with you?
Because she's in Switzerland, and it's also 12 p.m., so why would I...
Call.
But why would I eat dinner at 12 p.m.?
You could have lunch, and she could have dinner.
But I don't want lunch.
It's 12 p.m.,
yeah, but I, you know, I usually eat later.
Okay.
Like at four.
Are you sure she's going out to dinner with her family?
Yeah, because I actually talked to her mom as well.
Do you have her location on Messenger?
I don't have her location on Messenger, but I do have her location, yes.
Okay, good.
I have someone following her at all times.
Fantastic, man. Wait, is it your birthday today?
Yeah.
Oh, happy birthday, man.
Why did you pause? Why didn't you just say happy birthday? Like, what the fuck's so funny about that?
I forgot it's your birthday.
Oh, it's all right, man.
No, wait, why are you saying it like, did you call me for attention?
Yeah, I mean, not for attention, but like literally like none of my friends who I hang out with offline are on right now. None of my friends who I hang out with online are on right now, except for you.
Literally just like, no one's around to give me anything, so I'm going to call Zoil.
Well, no, it's just like...
I heard that,
listen,
that laugh.
No, listen. That's not exactly what I meant, though.
No, that is what you meant.
No, it's not. It's what I meant was, is like, oh, you know, my normal offline friends aren't here, so why don't I hang out with Zoil? I wish he was offline so I could hang out with him, but he's online, so I'm going to call him anyway. That's what I meant.
You
want to
hang out?
No, that's okay. That's fine. Don't worry.
Oh,
about
really?
It.
If I was to end stream right now, what would we do, Russell?
I mean, we could play some Valorant.
We could just play on stream.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, I guess you don't mind hitting 700 viewers, 500 viewers today?
Lower.
Yeah.
Lower.
You might as well be streaming my gameplay to at least keep them somewhat engaged.
Yeah. What? What does that mean? You think I'm bad at games?
I'm just really good at Valorant, that's all.
What rank are you?
well, I, I've I got placed a bit lower than I did last season, but right now I'm plat 1 and I'm 10 RR from plat 2, so...
I don't know what any of that means because I'm not a virgin, like you.
Oh, yeah, surely, right? I mean, this is literally the closest you've been to having pussy in your hand, so... Congrats, dude. What's your cat's name?
Bento.
What?
Bento. That's his name. Do you like it?
But why are they saying Warbo and Warby?
Because that's not its fucking name, bro.
Then what the fuck is Bento?
That's his name. That's his name. They're trying to call it Troy and fucking Dynamite, fucking Kittler, everything, bro. It's not his name.
I don't get it. Why Bento?
Because it's a cute name.
But what the fuck is a Bento?
It's a lunchbox in Japan.
Oh, so food.
All right, Russell. Have a good day, man. I hope you have a great rest of your birthday.
Wait. I'm sorry.
Russell, I hope you have a great birthday, man.
Don't
you live in a house full of friends, man? Like, is there really no one to hang around with?
Everyone is asleep too, bro.
Everyone's sleeping on your birthday.
Yes,
I take offense to that personally.
Listen, I've never, like, celebrated my birthday and done anything crazy, except for last year. But other than that, like, I don't really care for my birthday that much.
Can I come over?
Yeah, sure, man. Didn't you say you were going to come over? Actually, I'm pretty sure we had this conversation. I said, you were you want me to come over for your birthday? I was like,
serious.
Yeah, you should.
I actually would have come over for your birthday.
No, you would not have.
If you said, Zoyo, come over for my birthday, I would have come over for your birthday.
I did say that, though.
But then I got a cat, so I can't now.
Oh, so you can't fly with your cat? Maids take care of the cat?
But I just got him. I need to bond with him before I leave him. Otherwise, I'm going to, give him problems.
Oh, so you're going to bond with him and then abandon him?
No, I'm just saying, before I get, for example, my brother to look after him for a week,
Don't you guys look the same?
For a week.
Don't you guys look the same? I don't think he'll be able to tell the difference.
No, I'm more handsome.
Oh. More what? More handsome, right?
Handsome, okay. Charming, yeah. Funny.
Okay.
The list really just goes on and on.
Oh, okay, yeah, now that makes sense. You could... Never mind.
You could what? Go on.
No.
No, I want you to finish a sentence, Russell.
No. What are you going to do today? What's your plans?
I was going to... stall until I find something to do.
Really?
Yeah.
Has streaming been rough lately?
Bro, games, they're non-existent.
Yeah.
I'm very bored of
Me too.
Playing everything.
Same.
Reacting is fun sometimes, but not all the time.
No, reacting sucks. I hate reacting nowadays. No. The only thing I like is the button.
Oh, is that the cut thing?
Yeah, I love
that
shit.
That's just good as fuck. I love that.
My chat hates it, but I fucking love the button.
No, I love it, bro. Chat hates everything. There's nothing chat doesn't dislike.
That's true. Have you played the GTA campaign?
Yeah, a long time ago.
Play a little night.
See, is what you do is you said you wanted to you do stuff that you did back when you had no viewers, and you just react like you never did it.
Most of my old viewers are still here though.
Oh. Oh, name one. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Name one.
Okay.
Name three. Name three. Name five. Name five. Actually.
I got girlfriend. Bro, when you put me on the spot, how am I supposed to say them, bro? I can't when you put me on the spot. No. Listen, I swear, guys, I know all of you. You're all my friends. Guys, he's lying.
Yeah. Anyways. Yeah, no, that sounds... I mean, it depends on what you play, because I was going to just play Valorant, I'm not going to lie, but...
I ain't about that.
Yeah, no, I mean, I wasn't inviting you, I was just saying that's what I was going to do.
Yeah, I'm not going to play that, though.
Well, yeah, I know that, but I wasn't inviting you, so I don't know why you had...
Yeah, I wouldn't play that if you would invite me.
Yeah, but you didn't even have the option, is what I'm trying to say.
But I'm saying, there's no way that you could have invited me, because I would have said no before you even got the chance to.
Yeah, but there's no situation where I would have invited you because I would have never thought about inviting you, so there's no reason for you to tell me that.
You're fat.
Okay.
What can we play? Dude, if we got two more people, we can play Mario Party.
Mario... Actually, we're supposed to play Mario Party in person. Like, the boys.
Oh, recently, not me.
But we never did. I mean, you're not here if you want to fucking come here.
No, I know. I get what you're trying to say.
Oh, my fucking God, bro.
No. I get what you're trying to say.
Thinking of, what's your girlfriend doing right now?
I don't know, man.
Wait, what?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
I think she's at work.
Bro. I'm sick of this work shit, bro. There's no way that's real. I'm sick of hearing this shit.
Leave it alone, bro. She's working. She's busy. She's a productive human.
It'll be like 8 p.m. for me. You're like, yeah, she's at work. It'll be 8 a.m. for me. You're like, yeah, she's at work.
She's a hard worker. She's a hard worker, bro.
Okay, all right.
Unlike
buddy.
Fucking you, takes a day off every other day, Russell. Says me.
Dude, sometimes you need the mental break, you know, like.
I need a mental break right now, man. Honestly. I need a mental break. I'm about to go offline.
Hey, I'll take over, man. I got you. Don't worry.
No, you won't. Russell, why don't you go live, man? Okay. You got to farm those birthday subs. Guys, it's my birthday. I'm 23.
Well, yeah. I'm actually going live at 8 p.m. CST.
Oh, okay.
With the boys.
What are you doing about that stream?
We're going to be drinking and maybe play some games or something. I don't know.
What, in person?
Yeah.
At your house?
I think we're gonna do it at Eric's, actually.
Oh, nice.
Because he has, like, his stream room, so it's like he's got a couch and shit.
Yeah, could you, you know the stream rewards?
Yeah, where they had, like, the iPad.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want to do that?
Can you call me up on it, and I'll actually just be there on the couch?
I would, but we're actually probably gonna have Fillion's VTuber, on the iPad instead.
Oh, okay. Nah, yeah, I get it.
Yeah, I'm trying to open up the market, and I need, you know, and Fillion's also pretty cool, so, like, I just need, you know, I don't have more than one iPad. I'm not a rich guy, so, you know.
I know Eric has at least two.
Yeah, but he kind of, I think he sold it for Emmy's college fund.
He did not sell nothing, bro. If he sold it for anything, it's for alcohol, okay, not Emmy's college fund.
Listen, man, that's a shit excuse. I'm not trying to get my boy canceled, man. I'm lying for him right now.
Put me on the iPad, man, please. I want to be there for your birthday. Please, man, please.
Listen, man, I'll have to talk to Fillion about it, but I don't think we're going to be racking the videos, so, like, I don't know how you're going to make any jokes.
No, I'll drink. No, I won't.
I'm like, I don't know.
Bro,
I was going to say something,
I'm
but
sober now, from now on.
Wait, really?
Yeah, I'm never drinking alcohol ever again.
After that one time that you fell over?
Yeah. I'm over alcohol, bro. It's actually not even fun.
I disagree with that.
And also, you're on a diet, so don't drink too much, Russell.
Yeah, that's why I'm starving myself today, so I can just drink alcohol.
That is really unhealthy.
Yeah, Luna said the same thing. I was like, yeah, but just let me have fun. That's what I told her.
You should drink Captain Morgan's.
I don't know what the fuck that is.
This.
Drink spirits then? Buddy, spirits aren't real. Okay.
Drink this. This has the lowest calorie per shot.
How about I just drink vodka? Doesn't it have low calories?
It's lower than vodka.
Really?
Yeah.
But it's got, like, shit in it.
Yeah, but I looked it up, and this is lower than vodka. This has 50 calories.
Why is everybody saying not true and no, it's not?
Because they don't use Google. There's literally a thing called Google, and they believe their fucking their brain rather than using a quick search.
Hmm. Yeah, I don't know, man. I feel like vodka, I mean, isn't vodka like clear? Like I used to do vodka, I used to drink vodka only
bro,
when I was on keto.
Drink vodka then. I'm sorry. You can drink vodka, brother.
I'm just saying, I mean, yeah, I don't know, like.
I'm just telling you, from what I looked up, this is the lowest per calorie.
And you know what the thing is? I do believe you. I do, actually. I really do.
Well, look it up, bro.
But Captain Morgan is just dog shit.
I mean, I guess you drunk, though.
Yeah, but like...
Just drink Captain Morgan's and Coke Zero. Boom. Done.
Yeah, that's still disgusting.
No, it's not. That's good.
It is. Is there like Cranberry Zero? Is that a thing? Or like sugar-free cranberry juice?
Maybe. I don't know.
Yes. That's what I want. I would want a vodka cranberry, just get sugar-free cranberry.
Yeah, but that still has calories.
And everyone keeps talking about this meth shit. Like, should I try that shit or what?
Bro, I'm telling you, amphetamine is actually the fucking strat.
Like, I feel like it actually is, though. That's the thing. I keep seeing these ads. I was, like, in LA, and I kept seeing these billboards for a true weight loss clinic. And it's like you go in there.
Target.
I even saw it at
Target.
In Austin.
You billboards, bro.
Dude, they were actually.
Straight Target, you fucking billboards.
I saw one in Austin. I'm like, bro, should I just like go and see what's it? Like? They were like, yep, you're in and out. Like I'm like, damn. Like, is it that easy to win this shit?
What do you mean? You're in and out of what? Like, it's a surgery?
I don't know. I have no idea. It's the True Weight Loss Clinic. So maybe that's the move. Clinic. Yeah. Oh, now you're looking up. You're like, wait.
Wait, it is in Austin.
Yeah. I think I saw it in LA as well.
Bro, I don't know about this. This seems like sketch. Lose up to 30 pounds in only 28 days. We already lost more than that.
That's true. Well.
Wait, I did.
Yeah.
I mean.
Yeah, you did. Actually,
you're on your way to, though.
I think I'm like there. Yeah.
Yeah. See, like, this is probably a scam, bro. I wouldn't go here.
No, that's true. I was just thinking of, like, being your typical streamer and just, like, abusing Adderall instead, you know?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Wait, but those pictures have to be legit.
Yeah. Oh. These people are gonna pull the fat out of you somehow, man.
Yeah, so, probably.
You know, as you should go.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, go to the True Weight Loss Clinic.
What if it's like almost like an enema, but it's for your fat?
A what?
Like they like put the tube in your fucking belly button or something and suck all the fat out.
Is that called a liposuction?
Does liposuction do that?
Yeah, they stick like a Hoover on you and they suck it out like it's tubby custard.
No way.
They do, I'm pretty sure.
That's nuts.
Chat, my aunt got that. I'm pretty sure they put like a Hoover in your stomach and they suck it out.
What does Russell think the belly button's for? Well, isn't the belly button like attached to your penis somehow within the nerves?
Yeah, you've been fingering your belly button, haven't you? Like when you clean it out, when you clean out your belly button, you like feel it, don't you?
Why is everybody question marking me like I'm wrong though?
No, he's right. Like when you go to clean out your belly button, like in the shower, like you can feel it.
Yeah, you can feel it. It's a tingling feeling.
I'm pretty sure your stomach is your belly button is where your umbilical cord is connected.
I'm just gonna say this. Listen, chat, if you guys don't know like something on a topic, then just shut the fuck up. Like just type dot dot dot. Just don't type, okay? We don't need to see your fucking question marks.
We don't have to see your dumbass education. You clearly didn't get a good one, right? Use Google.
Yeah, like, if you're confused, don't type question mark, because you just don't know what you're talking about. You're making the streamers seem like they're dumb. No, I'm not dumb. I know what I'm talking about, bud.
Tell me, okay, put your finger in your belly, but no, don't do that. That's gross.
When I'm showering, because I put my finger in all the crevices. So when I'm showering, like, and I put my finger in my belly button, like, you just, like, it like, tingles your pee-pee a little bit.
Yeah, it does.
Do you sleep with that cat?
Yeah.
Really?
He sleeps next to me, yeah.
That's so cute. Bro, I feel like I'd be having a dream of me eating like a fucking hamburger. I just fucking put my whole mouth over that thing's head.
Bro, when he wakes up in the morning, though, he will, like, not leave me alone. Like, he'll wake up, he'll, like, go... He'll go below the blanket so I can't see him, then all of a sudden, he'll jump onto my face. Like, pounce straight onto my face. So this morning, what I did is I searched up videos for cats on YouTube, and it was just a bunch of red fish swimming around. I put that shit on my projector, and he was just staring at it for, like, 2 hours. he couldn't reach the projector, and he was just staring at the fucking fish go around. So that's a new strat. That's how I get an extra hour in bed in the morning now.
That's cute, and that's smart. Wait, you have a projector and not a TV?
Yeah.
What's with that? I don't like projectors.
Because projectors, first of all, easy to set up. If I want to move, I can take it with way easier.
But yeah, that's true. Okay.
And like getting a big ass TV is expensive, but getting a small projector that's good is cheaper and it's still the same size.
I guess.
And I only use it when I'm in bed, and when I'm in bed, I take off my glasses anyway. So even if it's not as good quality, I can't see it that well anyway. So,
your vision's that bad?
No, it's not that bad. It's just like I can't see it as well as I would.
But you're fat and blind. That's GG's, brother. You might as well just, you know,
bro,
go next.
You are literally, you have the same glasses as me.
Yeah, but like, I can see without my glasses very well.
I'm not wearing gloves. I can see as well. I'm just saying.
All right. How many fingers am I holding up?
I don't fucking know. Zero.
Yeah, see? There it is. I was holding
so
up three.
Fat, like a fucking fist, bro. Zero.
Okay. Like, what the fuck?
I don't fucking know. Put your camera on, actually. I want to see how you look today, Russell.
Oh, God. My room's actually a complete mess right now, but I'll do it.
Well, were you having a party in there last night?
Well, Luna got me a bunch of presents, and,
Wait, show us what Luna got you. Oh, no, this is for your stream.
Right? I don't mind, but, I actually don't have any pants on right now. I only have my boxers on, so don't show me.
We don't mind.
I'll put on my pants.
Oh, okay. I mean, you could just turn off your camera so I don't have to...
Or you could just not show me like a fucking good friend. And I can fucking whip out my cock for you if
bro!
You want. Fucking slang that thing around.
What's on that movement back there, huh?
Hey, relax! What the fuck? This guy's a fucking creep. Alright, I'm good now.
Bro.
She actually...
Alright.
What?
Nothing. Who are you watching up there on the TV? Why isn't my stream up there?
Ow! It was Nick.
Yeah, take it off, put me on.
Yeah, buddy, seeing you once is enough for me. I'm not gonna lie.
Okay. Were you born a cunt, or like, did you become one?
Okay, well, actually, you know what's funny? The people whom I go to are for watching is Nick... Or you, or Lenity, or
you watch Lenity.
Yeah.
She just. I don't watch Lenity, but she just watches the reality TV, right?
Yeah.
So you just watch the reality TV.
Yeah.
It's just cozy.
I watch her normal streams too sometimes.
What does she do? What's a normal stream for Lenity?
Reacting to something else other than reality TV.
Ah, that's good.
So yeah, it's pretty good. I'm scrolling, man.
It's comfy. Usually, it's just a bit messy right now.
I'm scrolling, man. I can't find. Holy.
Are you serious?
I actually have to hit view more right now.
Okay, unfollow some people, man. You have too many people you're following. Unfollow some people, man.
Okay. All right, man. I'll get to unfollowing people for you, man. Right.
Holy fuck! How far? There I am.
I do follow a lot of people. Like, I follow a lot of people.
You gotta unfollow some people, bro. That's not cool.
No, because they're all my friends.
Okay. Right, show us what Luna got you.
First shirt she got me.
Oh, bang. Shit. Nike Sports Sanctuary Club.
Yep.
That's a nice shirt, bro.
It is, actually. It's a very nice shirt.
That's nice.
Next, we have this shirt. What is so funny? What is so funny? What is so funny? What is so funny?
Nothing. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Nothing. Sorry, continue.
Are you good, man? You have a problem?
Someone said, I didn't know Nike made blankets.
Okay, good one, dude. Good one, man. All right.
Okay.
Like, you do realize that same joke applies to you, buddy. Yeah, literally.
And it's still funny.
All right, your shit's the size of the fucking American flag on the football field, all
okay,
right, buddy?
Okay, okay. All right. Okay.
Anyways.
What is that? That's a nice shirt.
Yeah. It says, Daddy? Oh, Day Social.
Oh, the back looks sick.
Day Social Design Club, London 2022. Not the biggest fan of the London.
Nah, that's a nice shirt. That's fucking hot.
Other than that, yeah, pretty good. And this is my favorite shirt that she got me right here.
Oh, she got you just shirts?
No.
Oh.
But this is my favorite shirt she got me, and that's this. It's the Volkswagen GTI.
Oh, shit. Shirt. Bro, getting clothes, like, for birthday and shit is so fun. Because you don't have to go out and get them yourself, and they're usually, like, just sick.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? That's a nice fucking shirt. Damn.
Yep.
That's
so,
nice, bro.
Yeah, I don't know. I thought it was a funny shirt because who the fuck would be sporting a Volkswagen shirt? So that's why I think it's funny, because I don't really care about cars.
Right.
So, yeah. She got me this.
Is that Prime?
It's Juvie. It's an 8-Shots energy drink.
Juvie?
It's an 8-Shots energy drink.
Isn't that what you kids get sent to instead of prison?
That is also true, too.
Is it good?
Yeah, I mean, this is the flavor that I like, so she knew that, and she got me some.
I never even heard of it. Juvie.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty good. And then she got me something else, but it's not here yet.
Oh, shit. Sure. Well, that's really nice, man.
Oh, and she, yeah. She got me breakfast as well, but I didn't eat that.
You didn't eat it?
No.
What was it?
Starbucks.
Russell. What Starbucks? What Starbucks breakfast did she get you?
She got me 2 Starbucks sandwiches.
And you ate them?
I said I didn't eat them.
She's trying to sabotage you, bro. Nah. She's trying to get you. She's like, I like my man big.
She's not.
She like that big boy.
She's not trying to. She's not trying to sabotage
you, brother.
He ate them both. No, I did not.
Show me them. Show me the fucking sandwiches. Why are you smiling, buddy? Where'd they go? Where'd they go?
I don't know. I think I threw them away.
You go get them.
How? I can't put my hands in the trash can.
Yes, you can. Come on.
Why would I do that, Zoro? That's gross.
Okay.
That's
gross. Hey, put your hands up. We caught you. You
hey. 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 No, I'm playing. They're right here.
Wait, he actually didn't eat them. What's the other one? He actually... You know, Russell? I'm proud of you, bro. I'm proud of you, bro.
Oh, wait, she got me something else, too. What the fuck?
I'll have it, though. Hey, honestly, I would have ate it. I'm going to be completely honest with you.
It's avocado spread.
I would have ate it.
I just, I wasn't hungry,
Holy
so I didn't eat
fuck.
It.
Holy fuck! Sorry.
I saw it in your stream in the background. Guys,
Bro.
You're gonna get him banned.
Holy shit.
That's funny. Yeah, I didn't want him. But
yeah,
I'll give him to someone in the house or something.
Everyone's sleeping.
Maybe I'll
right
get
now.
Hungry in like an hour or 2 hours, maybe.
No, you should get him out of your room.
Probably not,
that.
Though.
You should,
yeah, I mean, I'm not. They're
come
they
to
get
simply.
They're not worth it after like 30 minutes of them not being hot. So, probably won't eat it. In my opinion.
I don't think I've ever ate anything from Starbucks. No, I had the cake pop.
They have the good. The bacon sandwiches are good, but besides that, like.
No, the chicken sandwich, actually. The chicken sandwich was okay from there as well. Actually,
I remember talking about chicken sandwich.
They have a chicken, like a grilled chicken sandwich or something.
I don't think so.
Am I wrong?
Unless it's in like the UK or something. I don't think so. Dude, I'm like, I did a gym stream with Wake, and now I'm like, I think I was squatting wrong because now my lower back hurts.
Bro, I can't squat. If I like squat with a straight back, I fall over.
I mean, squatting with a straight back makes it a lot harder.
I will actually fall over if I do a squat with a straight back.
Yeah. And I think I was like, because I was like carrying like large weights. Did you shit? What was that? Did you just fart?
That was my cat fell.
Oh. I was like doing it with like large weights, and I think I had the incorrect form. And so now it's like hard for me to walk.
Oh, fuck. Is that why he's waddling over to the fucking bathroom earlier?
Yeah, because my fucking back is the fucking worst, man.
I've been in the gym nonstop, basically. And leg days have just been really putting me out, you know?
Wait, you've been in the gym?
Yeah.
Every day. Really?
Every day, man. Can't tell?
I can't tell if you're trolling right now.
Every day I've been in the gym, bro. 5 days a week.
Okay, yeah, you're trolling. All right.
No, 5 days a week. I'm in there, bro, on the ellipticals.
I feel like we've never talked about this.
Yeah, because we don't talk no more.
We don't talk anymore.
You're always busy, man.
That's not true. Not anymore. I was busy for a little bit, but I haven't been busy recently. Recently, I've been lacking on my busyness. I haven't really been doing much.
Well, if you want to hang out, Russell, I'm always down, bro.
Okay. Yeah, sounds good.
We haven't played anything in a while.
Yeah, I mean, you did ask me to play that Borrow Trauma game, and then you never said anything else.
Yeah, I couldn't get any more people for it. I don't have any friends, man.
Yeah, I mean, see, I can't exactly agree with that statement, but I'm sure it does suck being in that situation, so...
Yeah. you want to come to the UK?
Are you going to pay for the trip?
Yeah, but you have to actually stream.
Okay, I don't know what that's supposed to mean.
No, because I don't want you to have an excuse to ditch your viewers again.
Okay, for one, if I was in the UK, I would just... Like, I'm sure you could IRL stream around your area, right?
Yeah, there's some good places to do IRLs, actually, that I haven't done yet.
I have plans, but
I haven't done them yet.
Or a train to London?
London is literally like an hour away.
Yeah, a train there. It's easy. Yeah. It's like going...
You could go to the museums.
Yeah, exactly. Like the fucking the museum of paleontology.
The science museum. You ever been there?
No, I've never been there.
It's so fun, bro.
That does sound cool.
All the museums in London are so good, and they're like most of them are free.
Oh, so then, I mean, do you want to? Are you saying you're gonna pay for my trip there?
Yeah, but you have to go back home to the US. You're not allowed to go to Switzerland after.
What the fuck?
You're gonna ditch stream.
Bro, I could stream in Switzerland as well. What the fuck? We could both go there.
We know you can't, Russell.
What if we both go there?
I don't want to go to Switzerland.
Bro, Switzerland is way better than your poverty country.
Mads, can you fucking kill that guy, please?
I like the UK, man. It's not poverty either.
Yeah.
Switzerland isn't that rich, is it?
It's very rich. It's got the richest city in the world in it.
Oh, damn. Holy shit. I want to go after seeing your IRL streams.
Hello?
Here, so. Hello?
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 Zoil?
Yo. Can you hear me, chat?
Hello?
Try hard 7. Okay, someone type try. Bro, you actually. Hello?
Hello?
Yo.
Oh, there we go.
What the fuck was the point in that?
I couldn't hear you. What do you mean? Yeah, what was the point of that? Like.
Bro, how fucking long have those balloons been in your room? And how the fuck haven't they deflated yet?
since Luna's birthday party, so I could take out the air right now and get some helium.
Okay. Yeah, do it. Suck on it.
Oh wait, hold on.
Dude, I wanna do the one that makes your voice deep. I wanna suck on the one that makes you deep.
Oh, I got that one too.
Wait, have you actually?
Yeah.
Hey, yo, what up, girl? yo, what up, gang?
Oh, what fuck!
What up, y'all?
Wait, did you suck?
Y'all chillin'?
Wait, how did you do that?
What up, bud?
What do you mean? It's fucking... It's the balloon.
Wait, do it again?
Hey, yo, what up, y'all?
But how is it floating? Wouldn't it be falling?
Bro, I'm holding the fucking hole, jackass.
No, but if it made your voice deeper, it means that the density within the balloon would be heavier than air, which is normally in your lungs. Meaning look, the balloon would not float upwards, but would be on the ground.
No, it does float upwards. What? What type of... Huh? Are you good?
Yes, I'm very good, actually. What I just said made entire... Like, it made perfect
no,
sense.
No, it did not, bro. Just because your voice gets lower doesn't mean the balloon gets lower. Like, it wouldn't work if the
balloon's floating, it makes your voice higher because the density within the balloon is higher than the oxygen that's already in your air.
Okay, but then why is it working?
In your lungs.
But then why is it working?
I don't know. Because it ain't working and you're going, my name's Russell. You're doing like
anyways,
that.
No, I'm not. But anyways... I'm gonna cut open another hole and see what happens.
Am I dumb or what did I say makes sense, right?
Hello? Yo, dude, what up? I'm fucking lit right now. Holy shit, bro. I'm fucking high as fuck.
Where's XQC live? Russell, tell me. Tell Miz to go live, Russell, please.
Hold on.
Russell.
Hold on. I can't find the hole.
XQC. XQC, dude. What are you going live? XQC. Mischief. Mischief. I love you, Mischief.
Spin the wheel. Bankrupt. You sound like a South Park character. Ma'am.
Hello? Dude, spin the wheel. Oh my god, spin the wheel. Dude, spin the wheel.
You all sound right. Like Craig from South Park. Craig. This is so fucking good. My brother inhaled so much helium one point, his lips turned blue and he almost died.
Wait, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Can you do that?
Yeah. He wasn't getting really oxygen intake. His lips literally went blue and he passed out.
You really had to bring down the mood now, huh?
Oh, sorry.
Guess I'll just not do that then.
I'm sorry. Wait, no, you can continue. Hopefully it doesn't happen to you, man.
Nah, I'm kidding. I'm done, though. I don't want to...
You don't want to be a clown anymore?
Yeah, you kind of did scare me now, so now I don't want to do it.
Okay, my fault.
No, it's fine. Like, you know, it's
that was my daily trauma dump. I wouldn't do it again today.
Yeah, no, it's fine. That's kind of probably why people don't want to hang out with you, but it's okay.
Oh, okay. All right, man, well, I'll leave you to it.
Come on, man. I was joking.
No, I'll leave you to it, man. I gotta check my Reddit anyway. I've been live for like, all I right. think like 2 hours, and I haven't even been on my Reddit yet.
No, you're right. All right, man. I'll see you later.
All right, take care, brother.
All right. Have a nice day. Have a nice stream.
Bye.
Peace.
Johnny.
I love you. I love you.
Oh, I love you too, man. Oh, sensual.
Roast you, and then you'd love it. You text me, I love you, and then I fucking ghost you.
Big boys, mixed up. I feel so clean, like a money machine. Big boys coming with the big trucks.
Fucking dog shit off.
Huh?
Turn this dog shit off!
Alright, my fault. I'll play a good song.